It is the game in college football in Northern California each and every year. The fight for the axe, the big game, Stanford versus Cal, and it is next. Timeless sports memories sometimes take almost no time at all. And though decades pass, they remain forever etched into our minds.
There was only 4 seconds left, and the players took control.
Prior to the play, I know Richard Rodgers had got a group of guys together and just kind of said, hey, don't let the play die. The kickoff came right to me, and at that point, I was thinking, I'm going to score a touchdown. So I get the ball, take a few steps, and that's about as far as I got before I realized, hey, there's 3-4 Stanford guys running right at me, and I don't have a lot. I'm not going to get very far.
Ball comes loose, and the Bears have to get out of bounds. Rodgers along the sideline, another one. They're still in deep trouble at midfield. They tried to do a couple of... The ball is still loose as they get it to Rodgers. They give it back now to the 30. They're down to the 20. Oh, the band is out on the field. He's going to go into the end zone. He's going into the end zone. Will it count? The Bears have scored. The Bears have won. Oh, my God. The most amazing, sensational, dramatic, heart-rending, exciting, thrilling finish in the history of college.
Who knows
football.
What magical California moments will be revealed today as one of college football's most storied rivalries is renewed.
Live from Memorial Stadium on the campus of the University of California, it's the 105th Gridiron Clash between the Stanford University Cardinal and the California Golden Bears. ABC 7 Sports presents the 105th Big Game, the battle for Bay Area college football supremacy.
Buddy Tevens firing up his kids as we welcome you to Berkeley, California for the 105th edition of The Big Game, one of the longest and best rivalries in college football. It is Stanford versus Cal. How you doing, everybody? Larry Beal along with Martin Wyatt. Martin, what a difference a year makes. Last year, the head coaches in the big game were Tyrone Willingham and Tom Homo. They're both gone, and these programs have undergone some major changes, complete turnaround in Cal, and it really all started the day that they hired Jeff Tedford.
Yeah, Jeff Tedford brought order from chaos, brought in a new offensive system, and somehow instilled confidence in senior quarterback Kyle Bowler, who had struggled for 3 years. Now he's one of the best quarterbacks in the country. Bowler has thrown for 26 touchdowns in this wide-open offense. He's got a chance to become Cal's all-time leading passer today. He needs just 335 yards to catch Troy Taylor. So Bowler is probably Jeff Tedford's biggest fan.
Just having a year with him, you know, I feel like my confidence is back. You know, in the 3 years that I was at Cal, my confidence was shattered. I mean, it's tough going through 4-7, 3-8, and then 1-10. And to be a good quarterback, you need to be confident. You know, that's one of the big things that Coach Tedford's came in, and you know, I trust him, he trusts me. He's worked on my mechanics and fundamentals, just everything about my game. It's just been awesome.
On the flip side for Stanford, this season has been a real struggle for first-year head coach Buddy Tevens. The Cardinal coming in with a 2-8 record today.
Yeah, new coach, new system, and a freshman quarterback in Kyle Mitre to lead this, and that's equal, hey, a lot of mistakes and a lot of errors. But maybe now with the season basically under their belt, it'll all come together here in the big game so Stanford can finish on a high note.
Stanford, they've owned Cal in this series recently. They've beaten him 7 times in a row. No team in the history of this series has ever won 8 straight. Luke Powell, he was the man last year for Stanford with 2 touchdowns in this game. And Luke told me just a few minutes ago he is ready to go to try and beat the Bears again. Getting set for kickoff in Berkeley. We're back in just a moment. Welcome back to Berkeley, and this place is packed as we count down to kickoff in the 105th edition of The Big Game. Mike Schumann will be roaming the sidelines and countryside apparently today. Mike, up in tight water. What's going on up there? Well, Larry, you told me I had the best seat in the house today, but I didn't realize it was up here on Tightwad Hill, which Sports Illustrated says is the best place to watch a college football game outside of a stadium. Well, there's 24 seniors on this Cal Bear team that have never won a big game and have never had a winning season. They hope to kill two birds with one stone today. And, of course, we'll have the kickoff for the 105th version of the big game when we come back, and I'll try to find my way back down to the stadium. Welcome back to Berkeley. Getting set for the 105th edition of the big game. You see the series history right there. 54 wins, 39 losses, and 11 ties as Stanford has had the edge, especially recently. Here are the coaches. For the first time since 1972, both head coaches in this big game are new. Buddy Tevens, Eugene Francis Tevens III, if you prefer. That's why they call him Buddy.
Yeah.
And here is Jeff Tedford in his first season in Berkeley, a 6-5 record, former offensive coordinator at Oregon and Fresno State, has turned this program around fast.
Well, Larry, Stanford won the toss, but they deferred, so they're going to kick off here in the first half so they can receive in the second half. Of course, kicking off now, of course, is number 39.
Eric Johnson. Back deep for Cal. Number 8 is LaShawn Ward. And James Bethea is back there with him.
And LaShawn Ward, of course, is a game breaker. This guy had a 94-yard kick return against Arizona. He can do it. He's one of the big play men as far as the Cal Bears are concerned.
Stanford trying to put a positive finish on a 2-8 record thus far, while Cal comes in at 6-5, trying to lock up their first winning season since 1993. The Keith Gilbertson era. Those guys are ready, and we are ready as Johnson puts foot to leather on a short kick that Ward bobbles at the 10-yard line. Juking his way out to the 20, and Cal will have it first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Stop on the play by Gary Cobb. Bears led by quarterback Kyle Bowler, a senior playing his final game for the Bears. He's had a tremendous year. Three-time Pac-10 Player of the Week, needs just 335 yards to pass Troy Taylor as Cal's all-time passing leader. And we saw him in warm-ups, Martin. The guy has
he's
a
got
rocket.
A cannon, absolutely. And he's really worked on his mechanics, so his accuracy is so much better this year.
The first play of the season under Jeff Tedford, Cal ran a trick play. Coach said he didn't expect anything too funky in the opener of the big game. Bowler on first and 10. He's throwing the deep ball, and he has the shot.
Almost a great catch.
Can't hang on at the 25-yard line of Stanford as Cal tries to strike quickly. Colin Branch retreating defensively to try to make the play there.
Well, LaShawn Ward had two steps on Colin Branch, and the ball was thrown just a little bit.
Good protection on that play for Kyle Bowler. Up front, the strength of the offensive line is on the left side with Mark Wilson and Scott Tercero. Most of the game, Cal will go with a three-wide receiver set. Jonathan McConan, the leading receiver. They'll mix it up on the ground with little Joe Igber. Second down and 10 for the Bears, who tried to hit the home run on the very first play. They'll swing it out to McConan. That's a gain of 6. Drew Kaler, junior from Maryland, in on the stop. Stanford defense, they play a standard 4-3, led by number 99, big Matt Leonard, a defensive tackle. They'll rotate 11 guys up front on the down line. Linebackers young and athletic, led by Jared Newberry, a sophomore from Minneapolis. Colin Branch, the lone senior in the secondary, nurturing three sophomores around him. It's really been on-the-job training for the kids back there this season. Third down and about 3.5. Bowler as flags fly down the middle. Had McConan, but knocked away at the last second by O.J. Otagwe. And we'll see what the flag is.
It looks like a movement or some kind of a penalty in the offensive line. Yeah, it is. It's a procedure penalty.
Illegal procedure.
Cal's offensive line, one of those big guys moved.
Fire snap. False start on the offense. 5 yards. Third down.
Pac-10 officiating crew, Jack Folliard, the referee, giving the call, so it'll be third down and 9.
what's important for Stanford in this is they've got to start fast. This team has had so many bad things happen to them in this 2-8 season. If they can just be in the game for a quarter, then their confidence will rise.
Third and nine for Bowler of the Bears. Play action. Through his hands. Right. On the 40-yard line. I believe it was Jeff MacArthur.
MacArthur just come in for LaShawn Ward, and boy, that was a first down.
There was really nobody around him. That's just a drop.
A little wobbly pass. Came off kind of funny, but still, he should have had that one.
So Cal punts the ball away with Tyler Fredrickson. Luke Powell at the 40-yard line with some running room and brings it out to midfield. And Stanford with excellent field position to start out here.
Well, this is what Buddy Tevens wanted for a Stanford team. They made a stop. So his election to take to kick off the ball and to receive, not to receive, worked out for him. So they got great field position.
Stanford offense led by redshirt freshman quarterback Kyle Matter. It's his fifth start of the season in place of the injured Chris Lewis. 7 touchdowns and 8 interceptions. And they come out in the shotgun here on 1st and 10 with Kerry Carter and Casey Moore, seniors in the backfield. Inside give to Carter. He's going nowhere. Loss of a couple yards on the play. Marcus Daniels in the backfield quickly. The offensive line for Stanford hurt by the loss of guard Paul Wynak, but tackle Quame Harris. He's big time, 6'7", 308 pounds. Backs and receivers. Watch for number 5, Teo Johnson. Teams have basically been double-teaming Teo from the second he gets off the bus. But if he gets single coverage, Stanford will go to him. Carter, the single setback as Stanford goes with a double tight end look with Johnson in motion. And Matter will roll that flags fly, and this play does not count.
And it's another movement again on the offensive line. So that's going to go back.
Yeah, another procedure penalty. Maybe, you know, a little bit of nerves, some jitters. This is a huge game for these kids.
This is most of the Stanford players, their first big game. You look at them as far as they've got a very young team.
On the offense, 5
and
yards.
They're coming in 2-8, and they don't want to be the team to lose the axe. I mean, none of these guys have ever lost to Cal.
Think about this. The last time Cal beat Stanford, Tiger Woods was a freshman on campus in Palo Alto. Second down and 16. Again from the shotgun. Matter, a little hitch to Luke Powell. Knocked out of bounds by Jameel Powell. It's Powell versus Powell.
Yeah. You can see they're not taking any chances, but they do want to get the ball into the hands of the guys who can make a play.
The Bears led defensively by senior Tully Bantakane, coming in. He has 12 sacks on the season. 3 seniors at linebacker, Hosey, Daniels, and Nixon, all playing in their final game, hoping to finally beat Stanford. And in the secondary, it's Nnamdi Asamoah, the standout at corner. His brother plays for the Cardinals, so we got a little family feud working today. Last play was a pickup of 7, so 3rd down and 9 now as Matter works almost exclusively from the shotgun here. With time to throw. It's got Teo Johnson. That's a 1st down catch at the 40-yard line of Cal. James Bethea on the coverage.
Boy, he got a bad mark, Larry. That's inside the 1st down marker. I don't know if they're going to give him that one. I thought it was a bad mark. Well, just outside. He did get the mark. It is a 1st down. And there's their big play guy, Teo Johnson. How do you guard a 6'7 guy? You got to give him room because he has great speed.
6'7", 245-pound sophomore from San Diego. Teo, Stanford's leading receiver, coming in with 36 catches, 7 of them for touchdowns. 1st and 10, Stanford, their opening possession here from the Cal 40-yard line. Throwing a hitch to Ryan Wells. He's got room down the sideline. Breaks a tackle. Inside the 10-yard line, Ryan Wells, the senior from Middleton, Ohio.
That was a well-conceived play, well-written out. I mean, Ryan Wells just went inside Luke Powell. And they had to respect Luke Powell going deep, and so he was wide open. And a lot of room to run. Nice block out there thrown by Luke Powell as he gets out, breaks a tackle down the sideline. That's a big game. Stanford now at the 10-yard line. This is what they wanted. Something to give them some confidence to build on.
That was a gain of 30. Kerry Carter trying to check the play here as Kyle Matter is apparently changing it at the line of scrimmage. And we've got movement up front again. Kirk Chambers, I think, the left tackle, out of his stance a little bit too early.
Dead ball, false start, offense, 5 yards.
Mistakes and errors.
Three penalties already between the two teams.
Now this is early, and this is the big game, but watch this closely with Stanford because they're not the kind of team that can make up for these mistakes and errors. They don't get real estate in big chunks.
And this is the kind of problem that Stanford has had all year long. Make a big play, get within a few yards away from punching it in, and then something bad happens. Looks like Powell is about to take a direct snap here at quarterback.
And he
he's going to run it. Getting to the 10-yard line. And they gang stop him there, Donnie McCluskey, the freshman. All right, enough guy. They're going to be tackling him into the parking lot.
Well, they get the 5 yards back, but that is something new. You got to look at this again. They line Powell up as kind of a short punt situation, and he's not going to pass. And he picks it down and says, I'm going to run this football. That deep down in, I don't think he was going to pass anyway. I think it was just a fake, kind of a quarterback draw for him.
The Stanford coaches told us yesterday they were going to put Powell in the backfield occasionally. They come out with it on the first series here. Now Kerry Carter is back in as the tailback, and Matter is back under center. On second down and 10, here's Carter up the middle, stopped for a gain of 2.
Carter's not real fast, but he is strong and powerful, a guy that can hammer away. And he scored a lot of touchdowns in his career for Stanford.
Tom Zvercek on the stop. Big Kerry Carter. Senior from Ontario, Stanford's leading rusher, 490 yards in 9 games.
Big down. If they can get a touchdown, if they can get in there and score first, it would mean so much for this young Stanford team.
Third down. Goal to go from the 8-yard line. Matt.
Looking to tail.
Taylor Johnson.
Touchdown.
Touchdown. Boy, it took a long time for the official to finally put those arms up. Taylor was already doing his version of the Lambeau leap over there, but he beat Nnamdi Asamoah. And size matters. 6'7", Teo Johnson.
Well, Asamoah is 6'2", but how do you combat a basketball player? It wasn't a great pass, but it was just over Anamdi's head just enough where Teo would make the catch, and he made a fine catch.
Michael Skroy on for the extra point. Up and good. So Stanford strikes first here in the big game. You can throw the records out the window in this series. 7-0 Cardinal. Welcome back to Berkeley. 7-0 Stanford striking first thanks to Teo Johnson.
Yeah, he's wide to the left side by himself, and that's over 6'2", Asamoah, no chance. Ryan Wells and Luke Powell were flanked to the other side, and that left Asamoah man-on-man on 6'7", Teo Johnson. Nice catch. Just got the foot down for the touchdown.
Only need 1 foot down in the end zone in college football, and then Teo was up there in the Berkeley section going, yeah. Hi, guys, how do you like me? The kickoff here by Johnson, high end over end, but again short. McCluskey at the Cal 9-yard line. Weaving his way. Actually, that was Bethia out close to the 30-yard line where Cal will take over there. First and 10.
You can notice that the crowd here at Memorial Stadium has gotten very quiet. Stanford is on the board. They're a little bit shocked. They're back on their heels. But this crowd was up to see Cal finally win the big game, and I think that's kind of taken a little bit of the wind out of their sails.
Well, Cal had scored first in every game this season until now in the big game, and that's why we say, you know, the past records are meaningless because stuff happens in these games that you just can't predict. Second offensive series for Cal, running the option down the line of the pitch to Joe Igber. out to the 35-yard line. Lee Torrance up from his cornerback spot on the play.
Now Igber with 96 yards rushing today would become a 1,000-yard rusher. That'd be a first for a Cowback since 1993 back there at Lindsey Chapman. Keep your eye out for LaShawn Ward, number 8. He's flanked out here at the bottom of the screen because he's their big play guy.
Runs a 4-3, 40. Second down and 4. Short drop by Bowler. Going to his tight end, Tom Swoboda. Very close to the first down marker.
Swoboda, 6'4", 240. He's had a big year for them. A guy who's really come on. 7 touchdowns, and that leads Cal. So he's really done well for them.
And he was a forgotten man in the offense last year. Really not a factor. So he might be the happiest guy in town that Jeff Tedford has taken over this program.
Next to Kyle Bowler, yeah.
First down, Cal, at their own 40-yard line. The handoff to Igber, turning the corner. And inside Stanford territory at the 45-yard line, stopped by Otagwe. Another first down for the Bears.
Now you can see that this just opens right up for him. Able to get out to the edge, and he turns it on. Almost had the move on the outside to go back outside, but he was finally brought down. But they're well inside Stanford Cardinal territory now.
And because of the injury to Tyrrell Williams, Igber, his health is of huge importance because his backups are walk-ons. Here's Bowler on first down. Complete.
Wide open to McKeon.
Jonathan McConan on the catch. Stopped by Torrance. Let's go down to Mike Schumann with one of the heroes from big game past. Mike?
All right, Larry. Darren Nelson joined us, played from 77 to 81 down on the farm. What's your fondest memory of the big game?
My fondest memory happened right here on this field. Anytime you beat Cal here, it's a great memory. Fourth down, decide to go for it. Caught a little screen pass, caught in that end zone right over there to ice the game. That was my favorite memory.
And you went on to play 11 years in the NFL, now an associate athletic director, so things couldn't have worked out better.
That's true. You know, it's fun to be here watching this game. Sun's getting ready to come out. It's a great environment.
All right, Darren, thanks a lot. I'll see you, Larry.
Thanks, Mike. Going deep to the end zone. Caught. Touchdown. LaShawn Ward.
He caught that one over Stanley Wilson. Of course, LaShawn Ward is the guy they want to go to. He's their big play man. He was open earlier and almost had that touchdown pass, but it went off his fingertips in that first play from scrimmage for Cal. But that was a great route, beating Stanley Wilson in the corner of the end zone.
And Kyle Bowler put the ball right
it was a great
on
throw.
The money.
Absolutely.
Mark Jensen out for the extra point, senior from Pleasant Grove, Utah. Up and good. So Stanford scores first, but Cal strikes quickly. 3 first downs, and then they go to the end zone with Kyle Bowler hooking up with LaShawn Ward. We're tied at 7 in the big game. Back at Berkeley, tied up at 7 apiece, Kyle Bowler with his 27th touchdown pass of the season, Martin.
Yeah, flanked out on the right side, Jonathan McConan and LaShawn Ward, and that forced single coverage. Stanley Wilson just turned around too late. LaShawn Ward makes the fine catch, touchdown. And it was a great throw because Bowler recognized that Wilson wasn't looking. He threw it right behind his head. As soon as he turned, it was by him.
71 yards in 5 plays. Quick strike capability with Kyle Bowler at the helm. Well, you can tell it's not freezing here in Berkeley. Temperatures are in the 60s. Sunshine trying to peek through. Heavy overcast early in the morning.
And it's burning off, though. But back deep there for Stanford, you've got Ryan Wells and Grant Mason. Wells, with 20 more yards in kick returns, will hold a new Stanford career kickoff return yardage. So that's something for him.
Here's Mark Jensen. High kick. He's taken at the 2-yard line. Wells out past the 20-yard line to the 23, and that's where Stanford will take over on first down. You know, this has kind of been a Murphy's Law season for Stanford and Buddy Tevens. You know, a lot of stuff that could go wrong did go wrong. Early, they didn't have Chris Lewis, so Kyle Matter, redshirt freshman, had to play the very first game at Boston College, up by 10 at BC, a game you figure you're going to win. And one of your seniors, Casey Moore, has a crucial fumble. BC comes back to win. And then Chris Lewis, when he finally is able to play, he gets hurt. And it's just been one thing after another for Stanford this year. Never really able to get into a rhythm or get on track. First and 10 for Matter. We had a lot of time to throw. Going for Teo. And incomplete. Hit from behind by Nnamdi Asamoah.
Yeah, Teo was open for a second, but Asamoah came right back and made a nice play. You talk about these two quarterbacks. Well, Kyle Bowler, this is him in high school. He set a state record his senior year, 4,838 yards at Hart High in Newall, California. 59 touchdowns. He was the player of the year. This is Kyle Matter, same high school. He was a sophomore when Bowler was a senior. 81 touchdowns. He threw for 7,500 yards.
As we come back live, incomplete over the middle, intended for tight end Alex Smith. Matt Nixon on the coverage. I guess if you have a kid in Newhall, name him Kyle. He's got a chance to play quarterback.
At a big-time school, too, yeah. The thing about it, you look at Kyle Bowler. I mean, he gained, 10, 15 pounds in his senior year, in this past offseason. He's much stronger and more powerful. Kyle Matter, he's just a freshman. He's 18 years old. He's a kid. He's not that strong.
205 pounds. Doesn't have the rocket that Bowler possesses, but steady, can make the throws. And he's going down right there. Dropped for a sack. Tom Canada. Oh, Canada. The senior making a play in his final college game.
Yeah, Canada out of Hancock Junior College. And the thing I always remember about Hancock Junior College, John Madden coached there at one point. Tom Canada getting around. Matter really did not make, couldn't step up. He tried to step up. He was right there.
So on fourth down, Stanford will have to punt the ball away. Eric Johnson, whoa! Close to being blocked.
Not a good kick. No flags are down.
Great field position for Cal. As we take time out on the field, Stanford and Cal were tied at 7. 7.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Back to Berkeley in just a moment. Here's Jeff Tedford coaching his first big game. This guy watches more film than Roger Ebert. I mean, typically he's in his office from 7:30 in the morning till 12:30 at night. 3 or 4 days a week he sleeps in his office. We were in there yesterday. He's got this big blue inflatable mattress. I mean, he's a sleep train commercial waiting to happen right there. I mean, there's an endorsement deal just waiting to be done.
And a former quarterback at Fresno State, so he really knows the passing game, and that's what he's rubbed off with Kyle Bowler.
34-yard line of Stanford. Bowler has a man wide open. It's Mandarino, freshman.
He came out of the backfield. Nobody was there to pick him up. I mean, the linebacker was chasing him at that point.
Chris Mandarino out of Newport Beach, California.
And that's Jared Newberry, one of the linebackers trying to catch up. He had no chance. If he doesn't fall, it's a touchdown.
17-yard gain. That 17-yard shanked punt by Eric Johnson could prove to be very costly for Stanford here as you take a look at the offense versus defense. Here's Bowler on first down trying to step up. Eluding the pressure. And Kyle Bowler, one of the things that Tom Williams, the co-defensive coordinator at Stanford, said, that, hey, I know the guy has a rocket for an arm. I'm concerned about his scrambling ability because he can run.
He just showed some maneuverability there because Lewis Hobson Jr. had it for a sack. Pulled his way out of it. You'll see number 90. That's Lewis Hobson Jr. He has him dead to right. Nice move by Bowler. He's going to get what he can and take that and then go on to the next play.
Takes a possible loss and turns it into a 3-yard gain. Looks like Bowler's checking the play at the line of scrimmage. He's got Joe Igber in the backfield with him. Give on little Joe to draw. Breaks a tackle. Stutter step. To the 5. First down, Cal.
Ran right out of Matt Leonard's grasp. I mean, Leonard had him dead to right at that, but that was a missed tackle. Strong, powerful Joe Igber breaks it down and gets the first down.
Goes 5'8", 190 pounds, the senior.
There he is. There's the tackle that should have been made. Nice stutter move. Steps outside, gets another 5 yards, gets the first down. So it's first and goal.
Colin Branch saved the touchdown. First and goal for the Bears at the 5-yard line of Stanford. Igber needing only 2 more yards to go over 1,000 this season. It's going to be pretty close right there. I think he made it to the 3-yard line. Last Cal back to break 1,000 yards, Lindsey Chapman.
That was 1993. Absolutely. 1 yard away. You think he's going to get it on this drive? I suspect. They're going to pay him back for that nice run. I think he's going to get the ball. They're spreading him out. Man.
Double wide receiver to the left. McConan and MacArthur. It's a quarterback draw, and Bowler is swallowed up.
He is swarmed. I don't know if that was really a draw, a design play, that didn't get the handoff, because he didn't really, didn't open up as a draw to me.
Matt Leonard on the stop that pushes the Bears back here.
I think that was just botched.
Back to the 8-yard line now, so it'll be third and goal from the 8. We'll see what Jeff Tedford comes up with here. He's the offensive guru, has revitalized the Cal offensive attack. Igber, the lone tailback. And Bowler, the throw. Out into the flat, goes to Igber. They say he's out of bounds at the 1-yard line.
Well-conceived play. With both the wideouts lined out wide, they send the back out. It just made it really tough. Jared Newberry again, just overmatched, trying to catch up with him.
Fourth and one now, fourth and goal at the 1. What do you do here? You kick a field goal, you're going to try to punch it in?
I'm going to take it in. This is the big game. There's Jared Newberry trying to catch up. Won't be able to make it. He does get him out of bounds to prevent the touchdown.
Going to go for it on fourth and goal from the 1. Mandarino and Igber in the backfield. Double tight end set. Play action. Oh, Bowler lost the ball. Picked it up. And Stanford holds. They drop him at the 2-yard line. You know, he was trying to hold the ball behind his back.
Like a bootleg. And to hide the ball, to conceal the ball. And the ball just came out of his hands. This is a big break for Stanford. This is what they needed to keep them in it because they had to be down. Look at the replay and look at Bowler trying to tuck the ball away. It just flies out of his hands. He's lucky that they didn't pick it up. Of course, it was fourth down, so it didn't make any difference. They get the ball.
Weird things happen when these two teams get together. Babatunde, Oshinawa. Put the final stop on Bowler at the 2-yard line. That's where Stanford takes over. Casey Moore up the middle to the 10-yard line to give Stanford some operating room in the shadows of their own goalpost. Jameel Powell on the stop.
Casey, of course, is Mr. Big Game himself. The longest touchdown run in Big Game history. That happened as a freshman. And he was a freshman, 94 yards. Of course, he also had a touchdown that went in 2000 game right here in overtime.
25-yard catch for Casey Moore. He said he didn't even know, growing up in Florida, Big Game, what's that, Florida State.
Yeah.
He got a quick education. It was a 7-yard pickup. Now the give to Kerry Carter over the left side, close to the first down marker. Again, stopped by the senior, Jameel Powell.
The one thing Stanford has over Cal is that big offensive line. I mean, they are huge. They are outweighing Cal's defensive front. So this is something that they may look at really hard. Hey, maybe we can pound these guys and tire them out.
Well, across the front line, 307, 305, 295, 317, and 308.
And this is tough yardage down here. They've done well. It's third down and 1. They can make a first down.
Third and 1. Carter and Moore in the eye. The give to Carter. He's not going to make it. Driven back by a sea of blue shirts. Led by Burt Watts, the senior from New Jersey.
Boy, they rose up. and he had some help. That was a big stop by Cal because it keeps him in great field position. They should have good field position on the punt return. Look at that. He met him right there in the hole. Boy, stuck his head in there. And Kerry Carter, 6'2", 235. He's a load.
Bert Watts, the leading tackler for Cal this season, had 15 against USC.
Cal with the
pressure. Here's the punt. Eric Johnson moving it away. Jameer Powell taking it at the 46 and had it right down. Almost had a seam there, but still great field position with Cal in business now at the 35-yard line. Let's go down to Mike Schumann on this being the 20th anniversary of the play. Here's Mike with more on that.
Well, with the 20th anniversary of the play, we thought we'd break it down for you in the course of the day. And as we look back at it, here on the Cal kickoff return team, there's only four men on the front line. You see in there, one, two, three, four. Well, the rule says there's supposed to be five. And, of course, Cal only had 10 men on the field. Those are both penalties. You talk to any Stanford, former Stanford player, they want that axe back.
Yeah. You can get them started pretty easily when you talk about that play. Bowler throws incomplete.
A flag's down, though.
Down the sidelines intended for Jonathan McConan.
That might be a flag on Stanley Wilson, trying to guard McConan. Going to be pass interference or holding?
Pass interference.
Ooh, that's a big one.
Now, the one difference,
pass interference,
watch a lot of NFL
on
games.
On the defense, the penalty is 15 yards from the previous spot, automatic first down.
It's 15 yards, but in the NFL, you get the ball at the spot of the foul as opposed to a 15-yard penalty.
Yeah. I didn't think that was that big of a penalty, but he pushed him. He pushed him off. You know, in the college game, you got to let that receiver run free. He wasn't at the line of scrimmage. He was 15 yards down the field when he pushed him off. But that's a tough one for
Otagwe.
The young man, yeah, Otagwe.
So first and 10 for the Bears. Bola rolling out to his right, throwing back to the left side for Swoboda. Beautiful catch down at the Stanford 5-yard line.
Swoboda again coming up with a big play. Another well-conceived, well-designed play. All the action goes to the right. He looks back with that one long, the tight end, coming back, and he was wide open.
Gain of 16 over the top of freshman linebacker John Alston. We've seen Bowler put the ball on a line, throw a laser, here with a little bit of touch for his tight end.
And that was the perfect pass. The only way he's going to complete that one with the touch, because Alston was there with some fairly good coverage, because all the motion was going the other way to the right side.
First and goal from the 5-yard line. Callen and I trying to snap a 7-7 tie here in the first quarter. They give to Igber, weaving his way, looking for a crack in the defense, and there was nothing there. Will Svitek, the sophomore from Newberry Park, on the stop. This is a really interesting story with Svitek. He goes both ways. He plays defensive line. He'll play some tight end. He'll also play special teams. Now, there's a guy who should be getting paid for whatever he's doing today.
That's a 60-minute man. I tell you, you know who stepped up? Otagwe stepped up on that play. They were trying to sweep outside. He was there to meet it and force Igber back inside. That's what prevented that play from gaining any yardage.
Second and goal from the 5.5, call it the 6-yard line. Triple wide receiver to the right for Cal. Bowler tucks the ball behind his back again. Throws end zone intended for McConan and incomplete. On the coverage,
Lee Torrance. Yeah. That was some pretty good coverage. They had trips to the right. Just one long receiver on the left side. And Bowler did look on that way to the left side to fake them, but then he really wanted to go to the side of the trips.
And you see,
he pulled the trigger.
Receivers trying to run across to pick each other off, to pick their defenders off.
Torrance had a little help with the shirt.
That'll happen now and then.
He got it a little bit, yeah.
35% on third down for the Cal Bears throughout the season. They run a screen pass.
Almost. Could have been picked up because it was batted in the air by one of the Cardinal linemen. That
Trey
was a
Freeman.
Good play.
That's a pretty unusual call at the 5-yard line, running that what some call a jailbreak screen or a flame screen intended for LaShawn Ward. You usually run that at different spot on the field. He almost threw it right into Freeman's hands.
Trey Freeman, yeah. And they what they really was trying to do was a little inside screen. They had spread everybody out. They had double wide receivers on both sides of the field.
Here's Mark Jensen, a 23-yard attempt. He's 18 of 23 in field goal attempts this season. And he bangs it through. So Cal, after giving up the first touchdown, they come back and score the next 10 points. And really, the key there was getting the great field position off of the short punt.
Short punt.
To take a 10-7 lead.
And Stanford really has played well. I mean, basically, they prevented two touchdowns. They have given up the one field goal, but they were in position to score two touchdowns. Cal was, but they had saved it, and they've only given up the field goal in that series.
This is the 105th edition of the Big Game, and so many great moments from the past. We go back to 1974. Steve Bartkowski, an All-American, giving Cal a 20-19 lead, hooking up with Steve Rivera with 50 seconds left. But then freshman Guy Benjamin drove Stanford across midfield, and Mike Lankford kicked this 50-yard field goal as time ran out, and the Cardinal won it 22-20.
Now, the 10 points today, the 2002 Bears have set a modern-day school record. We got 407 points this season, so the old mark was 406 points in 11 games back in 1991.
Here's Jensen kicking off. Wells doing a tight row back along the sidelines, out past the 20, and dropped at the 27-yard line.
Well, Jeff Tedford came in with the reputation of being an offensive guru. Yeah, he has done that. School record in points scored for the Golden Bears under that man right now.
It's a 25-yard return.
It's a flag down at this point, and it's going to be against Stanford, so they're going to go back holding. That's going to take them back another 15.
Yeah, and field position has been huge in this game thus far.
And this, in Stanford, to its credit, is fighting hard because they've had the worst of the field position. They lost it on that bad punt, and they haven't been able to regain it yet. So they've got to put together a big drive to get at least, if not points, get back the field position. And they've hurt themselves already with that holding penalty on the kickoff.
Saw the numbers on Kyle Matter there, as they're still trying to position this ball for the spot here. They set it down at the 13-yard line. First and 10. Stanford trailing Cal 10-7 here in Berkeley. Four wide receivers set. And they'll swing it out. That's Luke Powell. That's at the 20-yard line. Nnamdi Asamoah on the tackle. He's moved around a lot this season, from safety over to corner. And when I was talking to Nnamdi, you know, last year we called him Asamoah.
Yeah.
And everybody just butchered. Look at the spelling on the back. I mean, nobody knows how to pronounce it. So I just said, look, easy way for you to tell everybody. Think hockey. Patrick Wah, all right? Asamoah.
Very good.
Nnamdi Asamoah. It's easy. His brother actually plays for Stanford, Chijoki Asamoah. There's a pickup of 8 yards by Luke Powell. Second down and two. As Matter changes the play at the line of scrimmage. Give on a draw to Kerry Carter. Got the first down. And out to the 27-yard line. Marcus Daniels, the senior from Los Angeles. Oldest guy on the team making the stop. He's 27 years old.
You know, Stanford is doing some interesting things. They're doing a lot of moving around of Luke Powell, trying to get him in position to make a play. Getting him inside so they can send the guy deep and then throw him the short pass, and maybe that he can make a big play for him. And it's not a high-risk pass. And that's what I see them doing.
You saw Buddy Tevens on the sideline. He's really had to rein in his offense because everybody was expecting, oh, fun and gun, it's Spurrier, it's Florida. There hasn't been much fun or gun because of a lot of the injury problems and mistakes that have been made. There's Tato Johnson getting free down the sideline for another first down. You know, it's so tough to play him man-to-man. Asamoah, again, in single coverage with Teo. They're trying to put height on height. At least the Cal DBs, they're trying to match up as best they can. A lot of teams have have tried to just double team Tail and take him out of the equation completely.
And Asamoah really probably is better as a safety. You know, I mean, he's going to be a good corner, but really he's probably his position is safety, but he's forced out there on the corner, and that's a tough one for him.
That was a gain of 19. So you talked about the swing in field position. Stanford's got it out by midfield. Again, they'll throw it down the line to Ryan Wells, the senior. McCloskey's got him and drops him after a gain of about four.
High percentage pass, throw the ball out. I mean, this is almost like the West Coast offense, but it's a longer pass in the West Coast offense. Throw the ball out there, let them run with the football.
And that's the final play of the first quarter. Cal leading Stanford 10-7. Back with more in just a moment in Berkeley.
Hey, the big game, of course, always has some big moments. How about the 75 big game? After losing the 74 big game on a last-second field goal, Bears All-American running back Chuck Muncy took the 75 big game into his own hands and legs. He ran for three touchdowns, and he would throw this 46-yard TD pass to Wesley Walker, Cal Robert Stanford, 48-15. The Bears share the Pac-10 title, or the Pac-8 title with UCLA. But the Bruins went to the Rose Bowl because they had the win over Kapp.
Chuck Muncy, remember, used to play the glasses.
The glasses, the big thick glasses. Yeah.
Here's the gift to Kerry Carter on second down and six as we start the second quarter. Donnie McCluskey, the freshman from La Puente, California, on the stop.
You know, Stanford seems to be working into a rhythm now offensively. They're taking a little short pass, running with the ball. They're hammering here and there with Carter. So they seem to now be picking up the rhythm, gaining in their confidence. I'm telling you, the Bears better put something on them, because these guys, if they get confidence, they do have talent. And the problem was not making mistakes.
Touchdown catch from earlier in this game. Matter. Roller to his left. Sets up. Intended for Wells. That's a really tough throw for him to make, coming all the way across the grain and trying to hit his man, Jameel Powell, on the coverage there.
Well, the good news, he did throw it so nobody else could get it. It was out of bounds. So it wasn't going to be picked off. But that was a very, very difficult throw. Tough decision for him to make. He really only had two receivers out on the route, so he really didn't have that many choices.
Johnson, the junior from Antioch, back to punt. Jameel Powell, number one, waiting for it. For Cal, high spiraling kick. Oh, this is a beauty. He's going to bound into the end zone for a touchback. Looked for a moment there like
he was going to stand up in the air.
The ball was going to stick.
Get a break, but it took a Cal bounce, and they get in the end zone, so they'll get the ball on the 20.
46-yard punt. No return, but when you take out the touchback yardage, it's really only net 26.
But still, for Stanford, you know, this is the time now they got to make a stand. They got to stop, because they haven't stopped Cal's offense in the last two series.
Cal with a 10-7 lead here, early second quarter. Larry Beal, Martin White, Mike Schumann on the sidelines. Off to little Joe Igber, gains about 2 or 3 yards as the pile moves. Kyle Bowler, well, Buddy Tevens knew that was the man he had to stop today.
I certainly have a tremendous respect and awareness of Kyle Bowler, a very talented quarterback. He's as good a QB as I've seen during the course of the season. He's a leader, he's a competitor, he makes plays, so you flush him from the pocket. He's a physical guy, he's not afraid to run. He has the ability to come off his primary or secondary receiver and just find a play to ad lib.
Sounds a lot like a high NFL draft pick, and that's what Bowler will be. He may be a first rounder come springtime, because the NFL scouts just love his talent, and he's finally been able to put it all together in his senior season after 3 years of misery. Cal called timeout, so we'll take one as well. Here in Berkeley, the 105th edition of The Big Game, and Jeff Tedford's Cal Bears with a 10-7 lead over Stanford. Coming right back. There's the gang, a tightwad hill.
Cheapskates.
Man, well, you saw Mike Schumann up there.
Yeah, Mike was having fun. He said, you know what, you got to hold on. You need a seatbelt, because you're almost sliding down that hill. there's the tree. A new tree.
Here's the give. Up the middle, it's Joe Igber, the little man from Honolulu. Started Iolani High School.
And if you notice on that play, Larry, they were setting up a reverse to the wide receiver round. They gave it to Igber and then faked to the wide receiver. So you better watch that one, because they're going to give that pretty soon to LaShawn Ward.
Gain of 11 yards. Igber now with 46 yards in this game. And there you see his season numbers for his career. He's up over the 2,900 mark into third place on Cal's all-time list. Russell White and Chuck Muncy are 1 and 2. Igber came into the game needing just over 90 yards to crack 1,000 for the season. Incomplete, intended down the sidelines right there for Jeff MacArthur.
Yeah, going for MacArthur, but even more than that, they were going against Stanley Wilson. If you've noticed, they've gone deep several times against Stanley Wilson, so it looks like they are kind of picking on him. That's a guy they think they can beat deep.
Take a look at the first quarter stats here.
And what's there to pick from? I mean, look at Stanford, 48 yards rushing. That's not bad to Cal's 29, but of course Cal has 95 to 54. I mean, just like the score, this is pretty close, 10 to 7.
Second down and 10 for Kyle Bowler. Four wide receiver set. Goes underneath, and it's dropped.
Sean Ward, right through his hands, trying to make a play. Because he knew he was going to get outside. He thought he could outrun coming over toward him was Torrance, Lee Torrance.
Ward has the great speed. The one problem that he's had in the past is the drops. And he has NFL aspirations, so he's going to have to work on that.
Tighten up.
Signaling in the plays.
You see those wristbands? They have the plays written out right there on their hands, on their wrists.
Here's Bowler. Down the middle, he's got it. It was wide open, right at the first down marker. Hit by Otagwe, the sophomore from Canada. But that's what makes him so dangerous. Joe Igber, little scat back, tough for linebackers. First to find him, and then to tackle him.
And he ran right by Jared Newberry. This is the second time. Newberry's really catching it tough. He's the guy that's got to pick up those backs coming out, maybe help out on the tight end. They got the first down, just made it, 10 yards.
Igber, born in Nigeria, went to school in Hawaii. Reminds me, if you remember Stanford guy a few years ago, Glenn Milburn?
Yeah.
Same kind of guy. And Glenn went on
fat. He had a 10-15-year career. Great punt return.
Glenn somehow wins the sack and scrambles as a flag flies at the tail end of the play. But man, Kyle Bowler just did a Houdini. He disappeared.
Trey Freeman right there on top of him. I mean, this guy's 6'3", 300 and some pounds. Yeah, it's holding against Cal. When you see a jailbreak like that, we're going to see holding, and we're going to see some escapability. Wow, right over him. Big Lewis Hobson again.
Now you see him, now you don't. I think Jonathan Giesel was the man caught for grabbing.
Holding on the offense, 10 yards, the spot of the foul, first down.
Well, Cal is sputtering a bit. They got it going, then they sputtered a bit. This is going to take them back. Maybe give some kind of a little push for the Stanford defenders. Look for number two on the left side, the cornerback here, Stanley Wilson. When he goes back deep, I'm noticing that Bowler seems to look that way to go down and challenge him.
Five penalties for 48 yards against the Cal Bears here.
And of course, that's LaShawn Ward already beat the Stanley Wilson for one touchdown.
First down and 16 as Bowler appears to be audibilizing at the line. He's got Mandarino and Igber behind him. Gives to Igber on the draw. They can't get it. They can't find it. To the 50, gets a downfield block. Little Joe Igber.
Great cutting ability by Joe Igber. Great vision and great cutting ability.
Gain of 28 yards.
Look at a lot of pressure.
Gain of 28 yards.
look at this move at the line, shakes off the linebacker right there, leaves him with his jock, and then just goes in and around. Boy, that is a great move. Lee Torrance had him ground to his back. Look at him again. Watch him just shake the linebacker here and leave his jock on the ground. Two of them. Woo, and then he'll turn Torrance all the way around. He's behind you, sir. Make the tackle. And Lee Torrance does.
It's a Victoria's Secrets play, because all that's left is your lingerie. Bowler with a pump and go. Good coverage down the field, so he'll take off. And he scrambles for another first down. That's what Buddy Tevens was concerned about coming into this game. Everybody talks about the arm of Kyle Bowler, but he could beat you with his feet.
And he did that time because he looked towards Stanley Wilson, trying to go to Jonathan McConan. Wilson had good coverage. He just pulled it back in and scrambled out to the other side.
Scramble for 12 and another Cal first down. Stanford defense seems like they're spending an awful lot of time on the field, and we've got
under duress
an injury on the far side. Well, it's not an injury, I guess. They're trying to signal an end to play.
I might
have had to repair the chain. It looked like everybody was huddled around. It looked like there was somebody hurt over there.
Yeah, they got the play in now.
Maybe just a bent chain as you look at Cal starting to pull away in the yardage category. Get 192 yards. First and 10 for Kyle Bowler. Well, he's got all day to throw.
Yeah,
Sean Ward.
With that much time, Stanley Wilson didn't have a chance. I mean, LeSean Ward put at least three different moves, fakes, on Stanley Wilson, and with that much time, it was a great job by Cal's offensive line. Protection for Kyle Bowler.
22-yard touchdown, and his second of the day to the speedy LeSean Ward.
It's going to be a long day for Stanley Wilson.
The extra point. Mark Jensen, and he missed it. He shanked it to the right. So Cal takes a 16-7 lead thanks to that man, LeSean Ward, his second touchdown of the game. It's a 9-point Cal Bear lead. Back in Berkeley, they may pass this guy around the whole afternoon. Oh, he's looking for his shoes. Good
and
luck,
his socks.
Kyle.
His shoes in one sock. Here's Kyle Bowler. This would just time Cal record for being responsible for 32 touchdowns. LeSean Ward just too much time on Stanley Wilson. Look at it again. I mean, Ward makes about three different fakes on Stanley Wilson, and he's wide open in the end zone because he eventually goes inside. But this gives Kyle Bowler 32 touchdowns in the season, 28 passing, three rushing, and one receiving. So that ties Pat Barnes' 1996 team record.
Kickoff taken by Ryan Wells at the 5-yard line, behind the wedge, out to the 28-yard line. Let's go down to Mike Schumann on the sidelines with another flashback as we continue to go back to the 1982 big game. Mike,
you made a touchdown catch in that big game in 1982 of the play, and that has to be your fondest memory.
Oh yes, definitely. You know, to go back 20 years from this day, and you know, to see Cal and Stanford, it just brings back great memories.
And you just told me that you played with Jeff Tedford in Calgary when he was a quarterback.
Exactly. Jeff and I played together in Calgary. He was my quarterback. I was a wide receiver. We had a, you know, great time up there. And it's great to see the success that he's brought back to California. I look forward to many years of him being here.
All right, Wes. Thanks a lot, buddy. Enjoy the game.
On first down, they swing it out to Grant Mason, and he is chopped down by Paul Ugenti, the senior linebacker from San Jose.
Now you see Cal making an adjustment defensively because they've said, hey, what they're doing, trying to do, spread us out and throw those little short passes. So they're the linebackers, Ugenti, they're cheating out a little bit so they can get there quicker and make the tackle on those short passes.
And moments ago we witnessed history, the missed extra point by Jensen, snapped his school record streak. He made 72 in a row, dating back to the 2000 season. It doesn't happen often. Cal showing blitz here with McCluskey. Now he's going to back out of it. Matter. incomplete off the fingertips of Teo Johnson. But, you know, this is, and maybe you can expand on this, for a freshman quarterback, he sees the blitz, he's going to check out of the play, then they don't come, and
he's stuck.
It's tough.
Yeah. You know, because he's already planning to make his adjustment, and then he has to go back to his original plan, and by that time, the timing is gone and it's off. Bob Gregory, though, is going to throw him a lot of different fronts, the defensive coordinator for the Cal Bears, because he knows he's a freshman, a guy that really hasn't seen a lot, inexperienced.
Third and 11. Now here comes the blitz. It's a draw. Kenneth Tolan into the game. He'll get nothing and like it. The ball may have popped loose at the tail end of the play. Let's see if they're down.
They've downed the ball, but the ball did pop loose. But Stanford really not trying to do anything too much. They basically were kind of giving up on that one, hoping to catch him with the draw play. But you can see that they're taking the safe route out with this freshman quarterback. That was Wendell Hunter.
Wendell Hunter is a big play guy for Cal. He's one of those guys who makes highlight reel kinds of plays. Fourth and 16, Johnson back out again to punt. His fourth punt of the day.
A better one this time.
Jamil Powell calls for a fair catch at his own 36-yard line. 44-yard punt, no return on the play. Let's go back to the 1987 big game. Brian Johnson with a big moment. Johnson was a 19-year-old redshirt freshman for Stanford. Completed the longest pass in big game history. Walter Batson, 82 yards, leading the Cardinal to victory. Of course, most people remember Johnson as the baseball player, the Giants catcher back in 1997.
One of the great home runs in Giants history against the Dodgers late in the season. Kept them out of the playoffs.
First down give to Igber. Out past the 40-yard line. Thought he might have dribbled the ball at the end of the play there. Looked like it came loose momentarily. And here's what they want. The axe. For 7 years, it's been in Stanford possession.
Stanford's going to have to play some offense to get the axe, to keep the axe, I tell you. You notice, if you look back at 1982, the score there, they have it.
Circle that, baby.
Yeah. 25.
How are you at finger painting?
There you go. It's gone.
Second down and 5. Oh, they fake the reverse and get the pitch to Igber with running room on the left sideline. Into Stanford territory, dropped by Osmago Otagwe. His friends call him OJ.
You've got so much to look for when you go against Cal and Tedford's offense. I mean, they had been running that dive play, then fake to the receiver coming across. This time, they pitch out to a back going the other way. I mean, there's so many keys that you better read properly or you're not going to get it.
First and 10. Bears trying to build on a 16-7 lead. Play action again for Bowler. Going deep down the sideline. Stanley Wilson.
They're going to have to give Stanley Wilson some help. I mean, LaShawn Ward would just run by him. If the ball was deeper, that's a touchdown because he had Stanley Wilson beat. He just needs some help out there. They're going to have to help him out.
You know, this is the part of the on-the-job training for the three sophomores in the Stanford secondary.
He's trying to make up ground. He just ran all over LaShawn Ward. He's going to get the penalty. The flag's thrown. But better the penalty than the touchdown.
Well, we talked about this yesterday with Tedford. As a defensive back, you have to decide what are you going to do? Are you going to play the man and not look at the ball at all? And if you play the man, then you try to reach in as Wilson did there. If you take a peek into the backfield and look at Bowler, well, then Ward
he's
runs
gone.
Right
it's
by you. So pick
gone.
Your poison.
Yeah.
First down and 10 for Cal. Bowler stepping up to elude the rush. Throws a one hopper to the sidelines, intended for McConan, but a flag is down.
Well, it's a good thing that was a one-hopper, because Stanley Wilson, I want to give him credit, he was all over Jonathan McConan at that point on that particular route. So if that ball had been up, he had a possible action at an interception.
Holding against Cal.
Well, Stanford's defenders have been out here most of this quarter, as you pointed out. And they're getting tired. They have to be getting tired. But more than that, it's the mental strain, the stress. That, man, how are we going to stop these guys? They're coming at us from all different angles. So they've got to find a way to get off the field.
Stanford rotates 11 defensive linemen. Let's take a look at the last five drives for the Cal Bear offense. They've started to crank it up. Like I said, they got that 16-7 lead. They'll rotate 11 guys up front to keep bodies fresh, but they're not consistently getting pressure on Kyle Bowler. Here, rolls out to the right. Deep down the field, he's got Bowler, and that's intercepted.
Beautiful. That is Lee Torrance.
Trying to get to the sideline. Beautiful play by Torrance as he brings it all the way back to the 26-yard line.
See, now, this time, Stanford, it was running a two-deep zone. That was the defense that helped them out. Now we're able to pick it up.
27-yard return off the interception, and Stanford takes over on offense, trailing 16-7. Come back live, Kerry Carter over the right side, stopped by Calvin Hosey. A big play, though, for Stanford there, Martin, because you don't want to get too far buried. You don't want to get too far in a hole. And LeSean Ward was looking for his third touchdown of the day.
Well, they saw him. They had one man, of course, that was LeSean Ward out there on the right side, flanked out. And basically, Lee Torrance was helping out. And he was able to make the move and come over and make the pick. That was a big play for you.
Second down and 10 for Stanford, trailing by nine here in the second quarter. They give to Carter on the draw. Gets to the outside to the 32-yard line, stopped by Jameel Powell.
Kerry Carter from Canada, 6'2", 235. Very powerful, very strong, but you can tell not the kind of moves as the Igber, because he had a one guy to beat there and he couldn't beat him.
Stanford would have liked to have used more of Kenneth Tolan in this game, but he's got a bad ankle. We saw him on one carry earlier. They may put Casey Moore in at tailback as opposed to the fullback position. But we'll see. So far, it's been mostly Kerry Carter. On third and five, Matt, here comes the blitz. Incomplete. Intended for Luke Powell.
Didn't have the time. Can't blame Matter on that one, but really didn't have the experience and the exposure to step back and try to get away from the rush. He just tried to get rid of the football.
Donnie McCleskey was bearing down on him, forcing the incompletion. So on fourth and five, Johnson with his fifth punt of the day. Some pressure. Still roots it out of there.
Boy, nice gamble by Jameel Powell. He ran up and picked that one off. That was a ball that a lot of guys would have let bounce.
Take a break. Cal gets the ball back on offense. Good field position right at the 50-yard line. They've got a 16-7 lead. Back in Berkeley. Martin, you've been around a long time. What is that?
That's not a hat. That is a man from outer space. Stanford did a great thing with the interception, but boy, their offense does a Lawrence well. A one and a two and a three and a punt, and they're right back on defense again.
That hurts.
Even the band is hurt, huh? Hey, that's Cal band. Yeah, look at him.
Got an injured band.
She's on IR. Play hurt, lady.
First and 10 for Cal. They're at their own 49-yard line. 234 yards of offense into the second quarter here as they hand it off to Igber, stopped by Jared Newberry. We continue our flashbacks to the 1982 big game and the play with more on the controversy. Mike Schumann.
Well, I love a Lawrence Welk reference in any college football game. As we go back to the play, we look at it again, and Dwight Garner, the freshman, was his knee down? Well, you ask any Stanford alumni, he was down, and the referee was behind him, could not see him. Just another reason that makes this play so special.
Yeah, the Stanford people are pretty much convinced that Dwight Garner was down. Going to the sidelines. McConan almost able to shake free.
Lee Torrance there just did pull him down.
McConan's a junior. He's a transfer from City College of San Francisco.
Yeah, George Rush with a great program there. They were the 2001 national champions. In fact, they're undefeated still. So
lose a game like De La Salle once every decade, you can be guaranteed they're going to lose a game. 9-yard pickup, so it's 3rd and 1 now. Mandarino and Igber in the eye. There's the secondary, and he is got Jagger. Touchdown call.
They spread you out. They hit those outside passes. They hit those deep passes, and they pop you with the little guy. Bam. It's a tough, tough combination.
That's what makes this Cal offense under Jeff Tedford. Nice jacket. So dynamic. And Joe Igber with that run goes over 1,000 yards for the season. There he is.
1,042. That's right up there with Lindsey Chapman. He is now, what, 3rd? Behind Chuck Muncy and Russell White. Those are some. Chuck Muncy, of course, a great name, and Russell White in the 80s, baby.
Extra points. Mark Jensen's got it back on track. And Cal starting to pull away here. 23-7. The Bearbackers enjoying the show put on by Little Joe. Coming back to Berkeley in just a moment.
Oh, film line.
This is the big game, and that man, Joe Igber, is having a big game. 12 carries, 138 yards, and this is a 42-yard touchdown. As soon as he broke through right there, it was over.
Yeah, Jake Kovac had the only opportunity, the linebacker, but he overran the hole, and that was it. He was popped clean because they had receivers flanked on both sides of the field. So there's your corners and there's your safeties. They end up chasing him. And no way they're going to catch.
The little man from Hawaii, aloha, means goodbye. Mark Jensen kicking it away. A short kick taken by Mason at his own 15-yard line. Twirls around like a top and gets out to the 28.
Stanford really has to be careful. I mean, the game is starting to get out of hand at this point. If nothing else, their offense has got to put together some kind of a drive so their defense won't be right back on the field again. That has been the problem. Their defense has been on the field most of this second quarter.
12-yard return, Jeremy Drake, one of the outstanding special teamers for Cal, made the stop. You see those guys starting to look tired over there.
And they're shaking their heads. That's not good body English when they're looking like in disgust and despair.
Unfortunately for Stanford, it's a look that they have worn much of this season. Matter will go out of the shotgun here. With double wide receivers left and right. Throws to Teo over the middle.
And the big man is powering his way, huh?
First down. How many men does it take to take Teo Johnson down? It
takes 4 at least.
Gain of 13.
Asamoah didn't pull him down. I tell you, that guy's a safety. They got him at corner, but he is strong, and he's a hitter.
Talked to Teo this week, and he said, you know, he had such high expectations this season. Fun and gun offense. There are people talking about him catching 70, 80, 90 balls, and he's under 40 as he came into this game. He said he's having a hard time sleeping because he's just so frustrated.
Yeah, I can understand it. Well, he can go on to basketball because that's what he will do. About as soon as this game is over, he's not going to immediately go, but within the next day or two, he will head to the Stanford basketball team.
And he's been working out on Sundays with the basketball. How about Mike Montgomery's team with a huge upset this week of Xavier?
Big upset. Xavier ranked 11th in the country. Nobody expected anything really. This is a big rebuilding game. Yeah, Nnamdi Asamoah, of course, his brother, Shioki, plays for Stanford, so he says it's hard for him to have a hate for Stanford because his brother's there.
It's amazing the things you'll hear. Like, they just can't stand Stanford. Like, you know, they're terrorists or something. You know, it's been pretty crazy. You know, the strange thing about that, I visit him all the time, so I kind of got to know their players. you know, outside of football. So I can't be like, yeah, I hate these guys. And, you know, Stanford, maybe as a university and as a team, as a whole, yeah, I'm against them. And, you know, I don't want to lose to them. But, you know, the people, I pretty much know the whole team. So I'm not, you know, that much against the players. I just hate losing to them.
Not sure he's going to lose to him today. Cal with a 23-7 lead. I saw Nnamdi before the game, a couple hours before. He was shaking hands with the Stanford players, some high fives. You know, he's friends with those guys. Fraternizing with the enemy.
Yeah, sort of. Yeah, they're Luke Powell. They're trying to find ways to get Luke Powell the ball so he can make a play. Now they just ran him with the football.
Wendell Hunter on the stop. Luke has been... Well, I asked him, you know, what are you, 70%, 75%? Most of the season, you know, he was coming back from a groin injury that's really lasted, you know, months, and then an ankle injury on top of it. He's the one guy that would resemble in skill some of the Florida receivers that the fun and gun is really made for. 2-yard gain on that first down play. Matt running for his life, trying to fling it out there. Incomplete, intended for Greg Camarillo, McCleskey, a freshman.
And for him to make that throw, he'd have been Brett Favre. He's running on a dead run, tried to just throw it with his arm. No way he's going to get that, but the pressure was just too much.
Kyle Matter, at one point in this season against USC, completed 15 passes in a row.
The first 15, yeah. And that was, when you see something like that, you see the skills and the potential that he has, and the potential that this offense has. They just haven't been able to put it together and keep it together.
Not consistently. Third down and 8. This place has come alive. Fans making noise. Matter steps up, and he goes down.
Matt Nixon was there.
Lorenzo Alexander as well, the sophomore from Berkeley, on the sack. Loss of 5, another punting situation for Stanford.
And Alexander, Lorenzo is only a sophomore, as you pointed out, but he may be their best lineman already as a sophomore.
Johnson getting a lot of work here. His 6th punt of the day. High spiral kick. This is nicely done. Jameel Powell takes it to his own 7-yard.
Nice block. He's got a hole and a lane.
And it's all going to come back. There's 2 flags everywhere.
A little overzealous in the blocking. You can't do that when the man has his back turned to you. So it's going to be some clip, and they're going to get 15 yarders on that. Jameel Powell is going to break a record for punt return yardage in this game, the way he's going, the way that Stanford has just not been able to put together anything consistently in offense. So the punter's getting a lot of work, and so is the punt returner.
Yeah, block in the back. I mean, they had everything on that play. It was a 55-yard punt. By the way, the paid attendance today?
70?
71,000.
There are 2 fouls on the play. Illegal block in the back on the return team. That's declined. Illegal block in the back on the return team. The penalties from the spot of the foul, half the distance, first down.
How do you know which illegal block in the back penalty you're supposed to take?
The one that's further, closer to their goal line.
Very good. That's it. All right.
71,000, is that included? No, that doesn't count. They got another 10,000 on Tidewater Hill.
You know, they got a lot of folks up there. First sellout here in Berkeley since the 1994 big game. Here's Joe Starkey, KGO Radio, for 28 years. And the man associated with the play as much as anybody for that heart-stopping call. We'll hear more of that at the half. That's a warning for the Stanford guys. Bowler stumbles in his end zone, and he's
got
the left of the field. LeSean Ward.
LeSean Ward had Stanley Wilson beat by 5 yards deep on this side. That was a 60-yard throw in the air. If he had been 70, it would have been a completion. If it had been 50, it would have been a completion.
How about Jeff Tedford in terms of guts? All right, we're backed up.
He's open.
Deep in the shadows of our own end zone here. Let's throw the bomb, huh?
It loosens everybody up. And that's why I think Igbert's going to be so successful continuing to run. and he's deep in the end zone at this point. Usually when a back is that deep, he's going to run the ball, and he is.
Up the middle for Igber.
You can tell when a back cheats and lines up deeper in the backfield so he can see the lanes open up. They'll get closer to the line of scrimmage when they have to make a block for passing because they don't want the guy taking a run when they're coming in, howling in the linebackers that they'll have to pick up.
Gain of four, so it's third down and six now from the Cal 8-yard line.
Now here's a tidbit. LaShawn Ward beat Stanley Wilson in the 2001 big meet in track. So he says, hey man, I own you. I know I'm faster than you, dude.
Yeah, that conversation may be taking place on every play. Flags fly as the ball flies over the middle, intended for the tight end Swoboda at the 25.
Well, there's definitely a flag at the line of scrimmage. Somebody was offside. I don't think the call was downfield, although the receiver was knocked down.
That's procedure against Cal.
Illegal formation on the offense, only six men on the line. That penalty is declined, fourth down.
That's the call that Stanford wanted in 1982. Not enough men on the line.
Yeah.
Not enough men on the line.
Again, we'll have more on the play coming up at the half. Fourth down, so Tyler Fredrickson will have to punt the ball away from his own end zone. Luke Powell, it is at the 50-yard line.
Well, Stanford should have great field position, and maybe this is the break they need to get them back into the game. A nice return, and they'll be right on the doorstep.
Low line drive kick. Powell takes it at the 43. Inside the 30-yard line of Cal, down to the 28-yard line. Short punt of only about 35 yards.
Peach Bowl bid slipped away for Stanford, and John Elway's first big game as a start. He fumbled twice deep in his own territory. Then Cal's Jay Tortorella would break the 21-21 tie with that touchdown. Cal would have a 28-21 victory. Elway would get revenge the next year, throwing for 245 yards and three scores. The Cardinal cruise 42-21. Tortorella, by the way, his real name is Jay. Played for the San Antonio Slingers of the USFL.
I like that name, San Antonio Slingers. 14-yard return on the punt. And Powell has put Stanford in pretty good shape here. Right, intercepted. Donnie McCluskey, the freshman, out in the flat, and I don't know if Matter ever saw him.
Matter just did not make a good decision on that throw. I mean, they threw it right into the teeth of the defense. And Donnie McCluskey makes the big catch, and right away, the Cardinal defense is back on the field. This has to be disheartening and discouraging. Just, he's looking right at him. I don't know, maybe he thought he could get it over his head, but the man was also covered by a cornerback there. Just not a good decision by the freshman, Kyle Madden.
There's McCluskey, freshman from La Puente. First down. Igber on the draw, going nowhere.
That's Trey Freeman and Matt Leonard inside.
Under 2 minutes to go in the second quarter here. And again, the Stanford defense is back out onto the field.
You're just not going to win a football game. Obviously, you got to find a way. First of all, they've got to find a way to get off the field. Secondly, the offense has got to find a way to keep the ball for a while, if not to score, but at least to keep get field position, which they have right now, but now can the defense hold them down?
See if Cal goes real conservative here on second and 12, just trying to get into the locker room with a big lead. No, Bowler's thrown. He's got McCone, and that's a first down out to the 37-yard line. Chijoki Asamoah, Nnamdi's brother, senior, on the tackle of Jonathan McCone.
They're trying to get some combinations in the Stanford secondary, trying to stop this passing attack. And Chijoki, Lisi was there to make the tackle.
At the 1 minute mark here, in the 105th edition of the big game, first and 10, Cal at their own 35-yard line. Igber looking for more. That's complete at the 45-yard line to Vincent Strang, the junior from Huntington Beach, transfer from Orange Coast College. This guy had a 55-yard touchdown catch against your Washington Huskies, Martin.
Yes, and we don't even want to talk about that. I think the greatest victory for Cal this season was up in Seattle. They ended that 27-year winning streak by Washington at home. That was a big win for them, and I think that said a lot for this program. Everybody knew that they had arrived on that victory.
Yeah, Strang is a walk-on, and
he may be the fastest guy on this team.
Yeah, only 155 pounds. And some of the players joke that he might break if somebody
If
they can catch him.
Right?
Yeah. Good point. But, yeah, you know, you're right. You talked about the victories for Cal this year that have been eye-opening. Certainly that game in Washington, third game of the season, going into East Lansing and knocking off a ranked Michigan State team at the time, made everybody go, whoa, what's going on in Berkeley?
That was before we found out that Michigan State was just ranked. They were also ranked, and they were ranked.
Yeah, you're right. But the chance with a victory here today to post their first winning season since 1993, they would go 7-5. And we should also mention that there is no bowl game possibility for Cal. The NCAA ruled earlier this week that even though they would be bowl eligible in terms of qualifying wins because of some previous violations, they gave them nine scholarships back.
So they were kind of saying, you're right, but yet we're not going to take everything away. The NC2A certainly didn't want to admit they were just totally wrong, but they did give them the scholarships back. That's important.
First and 10 for Bowler. Off the timeout. Oh, he gets away again. And now he stumbles down. Amon Gordon in on the rush. And we've seen Bowler, I think, at least two or three times in this game duck underneath.
He shows a lot of strength and balance being able to make that move. Not only being nimble enough to make the move, but strong enough, because these guys, we're talking about 280, 290, hanging on to him.
15 seconds to go as Bowler steps up and closes to the sidelines, and way out of bounds, incomplete.
He had pressure up the middle that time. When he stepped up, he had nowhere to go, and basically he was just getting rid of that football.
Third and 19.
With 11 seconds left, I would assume we're going to see a deep pass again.
Now, Jeff Tedford is not really a big fan of the kneel down before halftime. He's aggressive, attacking. And the Cal players have really responded to this new style.
And, you know, 7 years of frustration, never winning the action. Seven straight years, hey, they're going to go for it.
All right, Bowler, in the pass, throwing the deep out, intended for Strang, and incomplete. Well, now you got to punt the ball.
Now, bad things can happen on the play. Get blocked, it can be returned. So that's why a lot of coaches do take the kneel down philosophy. I don't want to take a chance and anything bad to happen. The guy could fumble the punt. So things can happen on a punt. So that's why the coaches take that conservative route.
And Fredrickson had three blocked this season.
Yeah, and bad things happen on kickoffs, as we know. At least Stanford knows. Five laterals, possibly. Yeah.
Last week, Arizona blocked a punt for a touchdown. Oh, some pressure there. And a short kick. And time's going to run out without Powell having a chance to return this ball. So Jeff Tedford gambled a little bit, trying to go for more points. But no problem for Cal as they punt the ball away safely and head off the field with a 23-7 halftime lead. Stanford scored first, you'll recall, on a Taylor Johnson touchdown catch in the corner of the end zone. Since then, it has been all Cal. 23 unanswered points for the Bears. Let's go down to the sidelines, Mike Schuman.
All right, Coach, a little sloppy on offense, but two touchdowns through the air, one on the ground. You got to be pleased.
Yeah, we're playing okay. We got to play a little bit better, be sharper in the second half. We've had a couple guys open. We need to hit them. And our defense is playing very well. We just got to play another half of it.
It is the big game. Go get ready for the second
half. Thank you.
All right, and of course, we've got the big game and the play coming up. Everything you wanted to know about it, stay tuned. Okay.
We went into the game thinking if we controlled Elway, we would have a chance to win the game. We scored some great catches. If you look at review the game, there's some miraculous end zone diving catches.
And this is for four.
We end up being ahead late in the game, and now Elway's got the ball, starts his drive. He's got it fourth and 17 with, you know, a minute or so left in the game.
And you're looking at John Elway, the greatest quarterback in the history of the college game. It could be his last play. Fourth down, 17. Throws for Harry. It's complete. Hold everything. Unbelievable.
At that point, you're feeling pretty frustrated. There's Stanford knocking on the door with the opportunity to go ahead with hardly any time on the clock. So I remember sitting around thinking, gosh, darn, how did we let this one get away?
He has a 32-yarder in this game. The big game hangs in the balance. You got to think about the center, the holder, and the kicker. All the pressure in the world.
You watch the winning field goal go through, and it was high-fiving ecstasy. It was just so crazy in the southern end of the stadium because it meant, one, we win the big game in incredibly dramatic fashion, and two, we're going to Birmingham, the Hall of Fame Bowl.
When you get down to 4 seconds in a football game, it's in the players' hands. I mean, there's not much, or if anything, that a coach can do with 4 seconds. I'm cool, I'm calm, I'm collected. Somebody said we had too many men on the field. I said, get somebody off. So that's why we had 10 men on the field. That's brilliant coaching.
You're holding your breath. You know, I wasn't on the field for the play because I wasn't on the kickoff team, but you know, you're holding your breath and you're thinking, let's just get those seconds off the clock, and you know, the play seemed to last forever.
There was only 4 seconds left, and the players took control.
Prior to the play, I know Richard Rodgers had got a group of guys together and just kind of said, hey, don't.
You're holding your breath. You know, I wasn't on the field for the play because I wasn't on the kickoff team, but you know, you're holding your breath and you're thinking, let's just get those seconds off the clock, and you know, the play seemed to last forever.
There was only 4 seconds left, and the players took control.
Prior to the play, I know Richard Rodgers had got a group of guys together and just kind of said, hey, don't let the play die. The kickoff came right to me, and at that point I was thinking, I'm gonna score a touchdown. So I get the ball, take a few steps, and that's about as far as I got before I realized, hey, there's four Stanford guys running right at me, and I'm not going to get very far. So at that point, I happened to look over and see Richard Rodgers on the sideline and just, hey, take it.
Harmon will probably try to swim it, and he does. Ball comes loose, and the Bears have to get out of bounds.
He doesn't get very far, turns around, and Dwight Garner just happens to be standing there asking for the ball.
Rodgers along the sideline, another one.
And I see Dwight cut back. I say, oh, we shouldn't do that. But then again, it's the players on the field that are going to get it done.
I saw Richard get the ball back again on a pretty close call from Dwight, you know, being pretty close to having his knee down. But he ekes it out right before he goes down.
They're still in deep trouble at midfield. They tried to do a couple of... The ball is still loose!
I was convinced myself for just a brief second that on the third lateral that the ball carrier had gone down.
Richard makes a great read. Nice pitch to Moret. He gets it, takes off.
And they get it to Rogers. They give it back now to the 30.
And all of a sudden, the ball's in the air. And when you look back at it, you see this guy diving through the air, taking out a Stanford guy, pitching the ball, you know, not really looking at where he's pitching it. And all of a sudden, I look up, and the ball's floating down in my arms.
They're down to the 20. All the band is out on the field.
And then things kind of start getting a little weird. I start my celebration and don't see Gary Tyrrell kind of coming out with his trombone and happen to kind of crown my celebration with him.
He's got it in the end zone! Will it count? The Bears have scored!
I turn around and see all kinds of folks running on the field. Some of my bandmates, the folks with the axe themselves, some of the players, the cow band. You know, it was just, chaos headed toward the field, and just turn around one more time, and just as I was about to do that, that's when I got just knocked over. I had no idea how he had gotten there with the football.
I think a lot of people today, they see the play and they assume that it was an instantaneous decision, and it's just an immediate call by the ref that it's a touchdown. It wasn't instantaneous. It was a minute and a half or two before they did it. And while we're ad-libbing through this and waiting, come on, give us an answer, suddenly the hands go up, and that's when I just lost it completely. The Bears have won?
The Bears have won! Oh, my God! The most amazing, sensational, dramatic, heart-rending, exciting, thrilling finish in the history of college football. California has won the big game over Stanford. Oh, excuse me for my voice, but I have never, never seen anything like it.
What I remember is when the whole incident was over and we were watching the officials make their decision and the touchdown sign went up, I told Bill Cooper and Tom Keating, our coaches, I said, let's get out of here before they change their mind.
After a game, we would all participate in grabasse and grab ass if you'd like.
And it's like keep away and there's no rules, but the ball does not hit the ground.
If you take that same kind of attitude in terms of, hey, just go have fun, loosen up and keep the ball going, that's exactly how it translated into that play. It was a bunch of guys playing grabasse.
It was not an accident. When you prepare yourself for that moment, that's what you call good luck.
Getting set for third quarter action in Berkeley. The Cal Bears with a 23-7 lead. Buddy Tevens looking for some more offense here in the third quarter. And just a few moments ago, Mike Schumann caught up with Buddy.
All right, Coach, we've got to play a full another half. What do you got to do to get the offense on track?
We just got to start playing. We're very conservative. We've got to put the ball down the field. We've got to make some plays. We need to protect the passer, make good decisions at the QB spot, catch some balls, and move it down. It's a two-score game right now. We'll come out with our ball right off the bat. We need to do something.
Why might you make a switch at quarterback with Chris Lewis?
Chris is not ready to go. He won't play today.
All right. Thanks, buddy.
Yeah, Chris Lewis. Got that lingering shoulder sprain,
yeah.
That's really been perplexing for the Stanford staff, because sometimes he'll come out, practice a Wednesday, practice Thursday, looks good, feels good Friday, can't move a shoulder.
Yeah, and they don't know, you know, if they're going to have surgery. There's a young kid, Kyle Matt. I mean, he's 18 years old. He comes in and is thrust into the situation where he's got to lead the team, and it really hasn't worked out. And you can see he's been overmatched a ton.
After scoring on their opening drive, Stanford punted six straight times and then the interception. See what they can do here to start the third quarter. That's Ryan Wells. Oh, shot down.
Big hit.
Big hit on the play.
And Cal with James Bethea there making the hit. Of course, he's their big hit guy. Bethea in the secondary, and he can make the move. All right, here's Kyle Madden. And can he get it turned around? Does he have the physical tools, really? I mean, he doesn't have the great arm strength.
Only 66 yards passing in the first half. And Stanford, you know, if you look at the statistics, their passing offense dead last in the Pac-10 this season at 179 yards a game. Usually you think Stanford, you think the aerial attack. And Matter will go up top on first down. He's got Luke Powell close to a first down.
And he's got the first down, and he went downfield. And this is what something Buddy Tevens was saying. Hey, we got to go downfield. We got to look downfield and make the right decision. And that's what they're going to have to do. Otherwise, everybody defensively is just crowding up, trying to cut off the short pass attack and the run with the football.
Stanford needs a drive here. They need points just to get some momentum back on their side. You saw the long faces in the crowd at halftime. Cal showing blitz here from the corners.
And got a movement by one of the Stanford offensive linemen. They're going to have to go back 5 yards. Well, they're talking about it. Maybe one of the Calmen actually tough, but I don't think they infringe in that neutral zone. Yep.
Procedure against Stanford.
Dead ball, false start, offense, 5 yards,
I mean, things start to snowball. You're trying so hard. We've got to pass protect. We've got to pass protect. The linemen are anxious then to get into their pass protecting stance. And then, you know, Cal, they're up 23-7. They know you got to pass. So they're coming. They're laying their ears back, and they're coming at it real hard. And that just makes it even more difficult for them to get back to pass.
First down 15 for Kyle Matter out of the shotgun. Throwing the screen to Luke Powell. Oh, he's drilled.
Whoa.
Wendell Hunter.
Big hit, and you said he's the big hit guy. And he came in. Boy, Powell thought he was going to have a corridor to run down, and he went back inside and met Mr. Hunter. Big hit.
That was a very difficult gain of one. A painful gain of one. Second down and 14. Three wide receivers set for Stanford. Now we got Bethea, press coverage against Teo Johnson. Looking for Teo. And that is open.
But not enough for the first down.
Driven out of bounds by Nnamdi Asamoah out at the 35-yard line. Still about 4 yards shy of the first down.
So now they got a big third down. And to keep this going, they're going to have to make at least 3, maybe 4 yards to make this first down and keep this drive going. To get something going here in the second half. You want to make some first downs. You want to at least start to establish something. And that's what they've got to do. So here's a big one. We'll see if they're going to be able to do it.
Well, we're getting a good spot. They call it third and two now. That's Teo in motion. Play action for Matter.
He's got Casey Moore open.
Scramble now. And he is dropped.
Now, Matter had Casey Moore open. If he looked at him, but he didn't throw the ball to him.
Tom Zvercek wrapping up the quarterback. Setting up fourth down. It looked like he had a moment.
When Casey Moore was open.
He had to release the ball.
That's what Tevens was talking about. We got to make good decisions. That was the decision to make.
Here's the punt by Johnson. Jamil Powell. Back at his own 16-yard line. Up the middle. Look out.
No way they're going to catch him.
Johnson giving chase. Touchdown Bears. Jamil Powell.
Jamil Powell is a big play kind of guy. He's got 5 interceptions. That was a beautiful move right up the gut. And once he got past the first line, nobody was going to catch him. He was gone.
84-yard return for Jamil Powell.
That is a dagger through the heart of the Cardinals. Cal hasn't even had an offensive play yet, and they have, yet they've scored. It's going to be 30-7, and their offense hasn't taken the field yet.
Here's Jensen for the extra point. It's good. I'm going to go one further. How about axe through the heart? We'll take a timeout. The Cal Bears, Jamil Powell, one of the seniors on this team, heading for the end zone and a 30-7 lead. The axe may not belong to Stanford much longer. Cal with 30 unanswered points and scoring off the punt return here early in the third quarter. Short kick is taken by one of the up men. I guess he called for a fair catch.
You don't see that often. You can do that on a kickoff, you can make a fair catch, and that's what
David Bergeron.
David Bergeron, I guess, didn't want to get hit, huh? Nah, he's a big lineman.
Well, you know, he doesn't want to fumble, but at the 15-yard line, you got to catch it and just give it back to either Grant Mason or Ryan Wells.
Exactly. He could have just handed it off and then make the block, but he made a fair catch, yeah. Fisher was right there on it. He was really waving, say, hey, come on over here and I'll give you the ball. The official thought it was a fair catch sign.
30-7. Kyle Matter out of the shotgun. That ball is tipped and that is intercepted. Paul Ugenti. The linebacker.
In the right spot at the right time. Coming back. and the old tip drill. And Matter not making another good decision. I mean, he threw right into the teeth of the defense.
Senior out of San Jose.
Let's go!
You can see it from Matter's view. I mean, he looks downfield, and there he throws it over. There's two guys there. Right, intended for Tail, but it was, you know, just not going to get an opportunity at that point.
Ball was tipped and picked. Here's Bowling. Swinging it out to Joe Igber. Makes one man miss. He takes it down around the 25-yard line.
Well, Igber has that kind of ability that the NFL scouts always look for. Will he make the one guy, the first guy, miss? And he always makes at least the first guy miss.
There's Buddy Tevens realizing this game could be out of hand. It may already be out of hand, but it could really get out of control here in the third quarter. We're still early third quarter.
Well, their offense has been, you know, since the second quarter on, has done nothing.
Kyle Bowler lofting it up to the corner, intended for LaShawn Ward. Pretty good coverage over there by T.J. Rushing, the freshman.
Well, they got the freshman in there to see what he can do to help cover it, because they've had some problems covering LaShawn Ward and of course, the other wide receivers. It's been tough for the defenders. Jonathan McConan, they just hadn't been able to cover him.
You see the wide receiver group for Stanford, they're all together. And we have Ryan Eklund warming up.
And they're all together saying, can somebody get us the football?
Well, Ryan Eklund is probably going to get a shot here pretty soon. Third and 10 for Kyle Bowler and the Cal Bears with a 30-7 lead. Got his man. I believe it's McConan.
Well, T.J. Rushing, the freshman, got worked on right there. That was man coverage.
Inside the 10-yard line. At a City College in San Francisco.
McConan just worked on it. Just makes it tough for the freshman. He's supposed to be their, about their number three cover guy. He's in there on their nickel.
Gain of 18. First and goal for the Cal Bears at the 7-yard line. Their offense has been like a machine today. Little pitch. Igber. I'll tell you, it's like tackling a mosquito.
He made the one guy miss, and fortunately for Stanford, they were able to close in on him, because really this is close quarters when you're down in the red zone.
Jared Newberry stopping for five. Imagine being a linebacker in open space and seeing Joe Igber. It's just, you know, you'd rather have some hulking 250-pound guy try to run you over.
Rumbling, that's, you know, you're going to make the hit.
You know you're going to get some contact,
exactly.
At least. Or with Igber, you just leap at shadows.
Well, Stanley Wilson has been benched, obviously, and the freshman is in there at the corner, T.J. Rushing. See if they work on him.
Throwback.
That might
be a lateral.
And it was a lateral. They were trying to throw back a tight end screen, basically. But that went backward. It had to be a lateral, and it is. So they're going to lose yardage on that.
Was intended for Mark Wilson,
the tight end,
and Lewis Hobson.
But he was eligible.
Right.
Yeah.
A lot of pressure. Yeah, that's a free ball right there. Lewis Hobson thought he might have a turnover himself there. That might be a little bit too exotic.
Yeah, that is an exotic, strange play that Tedford is known for writing them up those wee-wee hours.
Here's Bowler going to the end zone. He's open. It's incomplete. Flags down. I think
Lee Torrance didn't even turn around. His back was completely to the quarterback. The ball hit him on the shoulder. Now, I don't think if they're going to call face guarding or what, but that looks like it's that the offensive line was holding for Cal.
It was intended for LaShawn Ward, who had a step here.
He didn't even see it. The ball hits him on the helmet.
Yeah.
Well,
looked like he could play for the Earthquakes right there. Landon Donovan.
A header, and it's goal.
Penalties against Cal.
The good news, the penalties against Cal. The bad news, they're still going to kick this field goal.
Injury report, Otagwe just limped off, so the secondary taking a beating for Stanford in this game. This will be a 33-yard field goal attempt by Jensen from the left hash mark. Kick is up, and he missed it.
You know, that offensive play that they tried with the offensive line to throw him a lateral, they ran that for a touchdown against Air Force. So it's one of their exotic plays that has worked for Texas.
Well, the field goal doesn't work out right here, but Cal still up 30-7. In Berkeley. Oh, they got the mini helmets there.
The battle of the helmets.
Cal with a 37 lead as we flash back to 1947. The 0-8 Indians then had built an 18-14 lead over the 8-1 Bears. Future All-American Jackie Jensen found Paul Keckley with a jump pass at the Bear 35. 80 yards, then the longest pass play in big game history.
Jackie Jensen, hey, one of the great, great athletes out of Cal. Played Major League Baseball.
Stanford needs some athletes right now to step up and try to get them back into this game if possible. 30-7. Matter still in the game at quarterback for Stanford. Throwing short, and I believe that is complete. Alex Smith, the tight end, sophomore from Colorado. Brian Tremblay on the coverage.
Alex Smith, his father, Edwin, was an NFL player. He had 8 catches for 120 yards and a touchdown in today's game.
Alex Smith, really athletic tight end, but part of the problem for Stanford is the injuries this year. And they had Brett Pierce, who's going to be a stud, one of the best in the country. He got hurt early in the season, and it's just been a litany of things going wrong. Here's Kerry Carter over the right side. On second down and one, close to the first down marker, it will depend on the spot. Lorenzo Alexander.
It looks like they got it on this one. Yeah, it's close. They're not going to measure.
Keep the clock running, I believe. Well, might be one of the ideas for the refs right now.
It'll be very short in third.
There's Matt Leonard, defensive tackle for Stanford. You might see him playing on Sundays next year. Third and one. It was not a first down. They give to Carter over the right side. He's got the first down and ridden out of bounds. Jameel Powell on the stop. Gain of 6.
Stanford's best defense so far has been the missed kick. They missed an extra point and they missed the field goal.
You know, the hard thing here for Stanford, if you feel the strength of your offense is running the ball, that's fine.
Yeah.
Early in the game, but when you're down 30-7, it's hard to run off tackle and make a comeback. Three wide set with Carter in the backfield. Matter eludes one man.
Nice move.
On the scramble. Wow, nice job by the freshman. Kyle Matter out to midfield. Donnie McCleskey.
Well, he made a nice decision there, but, you know, you got to get the ball downfield. And he did what he had to do. He avoided one guy, but you would hope that he could have stopped and found the receiver open downfield, get it into his hands, and hopefully they can make a big play.
McCleskey's a true freshman, moved in at the rover back, kind of a safety position, when Nnamdi Asamoah moved out to corner. So McCleskey's played a lot in the last few games. High formation, first down for the Cardinal at their own 49-yard line. This is the give again up the middle to Carter. But he's a bruiser. He'll carry guys. And he takes it into Cal territory at the 47-yard line.
Well, it's 30-7. It's not impossible. But they're going to have to get something going on this drive to bring it back to a possible 2-touchdown game.
Second and 6.
And that would be with 2-point conversion.
Casey Moore, now the lone setback behind Matter. Straight back to pass. Looking for Taylor with a deep ball.
They have him. Oh.
Pass interference going to be called on Asamoah. Well, see here, you know, you have a guy who's 6'7", 245. Let him go make a play, or at the very worst, get pass interference.
It's the Terrell Owens philosophy. Hey, I can beat my guy. Throw the ball up, I'll make a play. They're battling down the sideline. Asamoah and Teo Johnson. And Teo's going to win that battle. He's 6'7". He almost made the catch.
Teo in the mold of Tony Gonzalez of the Chiefs. You know, both basketball players
as
well.
Yeah. Very good basketball players. Teo, of course, playing with Stanford and Mike Montgomery. He played with a real good team with the Collins. These guys were down to the Sweet 16. And he was a big contributor.
So the penalty moves the ball to the Cal 32-yard line. Matter looks to be checking off.
Luke Powell is man on man. Watch out for Luke.
And they're going to Ryan Wells. So that ball was almost picked off.
Asamoah made a great jump on the ball. Asamoah was right there, made a jump on Ryan Wells. He was sitting right on that movement.
Let's go down to Mike Schumann.
All right, joining me now, Jack Hart, a member of the 1959 Cal team that went to the Rose Bowl, teammate of Joe Capps, now the director of the East-West Shrine Game, which is this year at Pac Bell Park.
That's correct. January 11th, we're going to kick it off at 11 o'clock. So let's have some fans come join us.
And we have some local players in the game this
year. Absolutely. We've got a great Stanford-Cal tradition, obviously. This year we have three guys off the Stanford team and two guys off the Cal team, and we're looking forward to having them with us.
All right, Jack, thanks for joining us. Back to the action.
Good.
All right, thanks, Mike. On second down and 10, Matter rolling, spinning away. So he's done a good job running the ball. He's paying the price.
Yeah, he's paying the price, but, you know, he's got to make completions at this particular, you know, at this point. You're down 30-7. You didn't have much chance then, but it's difficult for a young quarterback, once he's under siege, to continue to look downfield for open receivers. And that's just very difficult. That's something you learn with experience.
You set up third down and 8 as you looked at the third down conversion numbers there. Neither team really lighting it up on third down. Matt Nixon made that last stop. Senior linebacker for Cal playing his final game here in Berkeley. Cal showing blitz on third and 8.
Here they
picked
come.
Up. Matter flushed out to the
He's
right
looking
side.
For it, man. Give him some help.
He's going to run, and he gains about 2 or 3 yards on the play.
Well, Matter that time, he saw the pressure. He got outside. He motioned for Teo to go deep. Teo tried to come back to help him out, but at that point, he was covered by Asamoah.
Gain of 3, so it's 4th down and 5 yards to go.
You might as well
might
go.
Might as well
for
go, right? You're down 30-7.
You're inside, they're 30, you're down 30-7, you go for the 4.
Luke Powell and Ryan Wells both check out. You see what they're going to run here. It's Teo and Grant Mason split left, and Stanford needs a timeout. I'm not sure they have the right personnel on the field.
Yeah.
So I'm facing 4th down. I want Luke Powell
out
there.
I want Luke Powell on the field. I want Ryan Wells.
We'll take a timeout along with Stanford. 30-7, the Cal Bears on their way to retaining that axe. 4th down and 5, and Stanford is going to go for it from the Cal 27-yard line. 4 wide receivers set with Casey Moore in the backfield. Cal showing blitz. Matter, short drop, pump, his arm is hit, deflected and incomplete. I think he was going for Grant Mason, but the ball never had a chance.
No chance, and he made the short drop. He maybe should have dropped back a little bit more to give himself some cushion, but he was hoping for the quick. It just wasn't there. You know, this is a tough one for a young guy. He's 18 years old. Look at him. He'll make the short drop, right? Steps up. Now he needs to step back to avoid that. He steps into it instead, and he gets hammered.
Tully Bantakane putting the pressure on and prevented Matter from following through with the football. So Cal takes over at their own 27-yard line. 1st and 10 for Kyle Bowler and company. They're up big, 30-7. Joe Igber up the middle. Probably going to see a lot of running plays here as the only thing standing between Cal getting that axe back
is the clock.
Yeah, and Igber already with a big first half, 140 yards in the first half. We could see him churn up a lot of yardage on this day. Look at that. Igber, 148 yards rushing to Stanford, total rushing yards for their team, 72 yards. And you know what? Matter got about 15 of those in the last possession.
Here's Bowler with another gift to little Joe. Close to the first down line, and you see the strength in the lower body.
Yeah.
Lee Torrance
just fighting for the yardage, trying to move the chains, and that's what he did. They're going to keep possession of the football.
Nolan Blunzer is in at center for Cal as Teo Johnson looks on there. Hoping to get more chances on offense, but the Stanford defense has been on the field so much this afternoon.
Well,
first
and
10 for Cal.
Yeah, and the freshman's out here on single coverage, way wide by himself.
On the shift to Igber. Gain of about five. Otagwe on the stop. Kyle Bowler has a chance to become Cal's all-time leading passer. Needs 335 yards to catch Pat Barnes. Here's Kyle's thoughts.
Wins are ultimately what I care about. I mean, I could throw for one touchdown or, you know, throw for 5 yards as long as we win. I think records are something that's going to be awesome to look back and say, you know, I was, you know, there's a lot of great quarterbacks, Craig Morton, all these guys that, you know, and I'm at the top of the list for all those guys. And I have an opportunity to break the all-time passing yardage and, you know, Troy Taylor. So I just feel blessed to be a part of it.
Another handoff here up the middle. I'm not sure Bowler's going to get enough attempts in this game.
He's not going to get a chance. I mean, obviously, Tedford is kind of called the dogs off right now, just trying to run the clock down. Because they were really having their way with the Stanford corners. And in fact, they had it so much that Stanley Wilson got benched. And they brought in the freshman at one corner.
Unofficially, we got Bowler with 178 passing yards. I'm not sure Jeff Tedford is going to look to air it out here with a 30-7 lead. It's going to be a steady
down,
guy.
He'll go now.
Joe Igber most of the way. There's McConan close to the first down marker.
And he got the good mark. He's got the first down. And they went right at the freshman.
Calvin Armstrong, a freshman from Decatur, Georgia. And a gain of five. That's exactly what they needed for the first down. McConan, we talked about when coming from City College of San Francisco. And a really disturbing story as I met with him for a few minutes, Martin. He told me that he was all set to sign with my alma mater, University of Hawaii, was waiting by the fax machine when out of the blue he got a call from Jeff Tedford. And at the last moment, he changed his mind and decided to come to Cal.
Oh,
here's Igber dancing at the 50-yard line. I told Jonathan, I said, Jonathan, that, you know, I'm happy for you. You've had a great year. But you better catch every ball because I'm going to have to rip you otherwise.
Yeah. Of course, you know, Hawaii is really putting out some great athletes there. That number one pick for Denver Broncos, Ashley Lilly, and that quarterback they have there that they've got going now that's going to be a great quarterback.
Yeah.
In fact, they're talking about maybe Heisman in a year or two for him.
Yeah, June Jones is certainly very high on his quarterback, Timmy Chang. This is another great offense to be in at Cal now.
They're determined to run the football.
Joe Igber.
And Stanford is relishing that. They're recognizing it and starting to cheat up inside the lineman. So Tedford may decide to unwrap one more pass attack and just go up top.
Under a minute to go in the third quarter with Cal up big 30-7. This would be the culmination of a great turnaround season for that man and this program because it was down for a long time.
He's done a marvelous job, and we'll talk about some of that later on in this broadcast.
Third and 12 for Bowler. Under pressure, and he's dropped, and a flag comes down late.
Yeah.
Babatunde Oshinawa on the stop. I love the name. He's a freshman.
That is a melodious name. Babatunde Oshinawa. Yep. It's holding against Cal.
Yeah, they'll decline that. Offense penalty is declined.
Fourth down.
So Cal will have to punt. Luke Powell trying to make a big play back at his own 23-yard line, hoping for some sort of a return.
He's got four returns, 105 yards. Of course, that 84-yarder for the touchdown. So.
Yeah, you're thinking of Jameel Powell.
Jameel Powell, I'm sorry. You got Luke Powell. That ain't going to work.
And Stanford unable to return this thing as Luke had to retreat at the last minute. Down at the 15-yard line, so no return possible there. We'll take a break. Stanford takes over on offense. 30-7, the Cal Bears in front. We're back, 15 minutes to go in the 105th big game in Berkeley. Cal with a 30-7 lead. Back down to the sidelines, Mike Schumann.
Well, if we haven't seen enough of the play, we have what Stanford fans think is the final infraction on that play. Marriott Ford, watch his lateral. He's at the 27-yard line, and Kevin Moen catches the ball at the 25. That's a forward lateral, or there's some physics involved. And, you know, being from Florida State, I'll have to go ask the Stanford player about that physics thing.
Line. And, you know, I think it's an optical illusion because he threw it over his shoulder. I know all the Stanford people right now are, you know, trying to kick the TV set in as I say that, but I'm not sure how that happened.
Yeah, well, the reason the referee couldn't even make the call, he fell down, tripped over a band member. He wasn't even in position. There's no way. He didn't even see the lateral, so it wasn't going to be a call regardless.
And Stanford needs more than a play. They need a whole bunch of plays here, and Kerry Carter over the right side for 5 yards. I don't know what you could really do. I mean, if you don't feel you can really throw the ball, basically you're just running the clock out, and that's kind of Buddy Teeven's dilemma at this point.
Well, he's going to have to go downfield. I mean, obviously, look at the stats. I mean, man, if the first quarter it was pretty even, but now it's overwhelming. Yeah, look at that, 324 yards. 171 total for Stanford.
Justin Faust has checked into the game. The tailback for Stanford. The throws to Alex Smith, the tight end. And he's got it. That's a first down catch out to the 32-yard line. Burt Watts on the coverage.
Yeah, Marcus Daniels tried for the interception. He was there on the coverage and just missed it, the linebacker.
Take a look at the USC score. Wow.
Trojans up big.
42-7 over the Bruins of UCLA. Yeah, the Trojans might be playing the best football of anybody in the Pac-10 right about now. Here's Matter. Under pressure. He's going down at the 25-yard line. Sacked on the play. Josh Beckham first to make contact in the backfield. You know that SC-UCLA game? You know, a big rivalry game.
Yeah.
The winner gets a jar of smog to go as part of the trophy presentation.
And this one here, you get a jar of rain, the Civil War. Yeah. And of course, at Washington, you get an apple.
Apple Cup. Right. Yeah. Washington State, actually, you know, excellent team, but number 3 in the BCS rankings.
Maybe something could happen. They might move up because Ohio State
Ohio
won.
Ohio State took care of business. If Miami wins out, then it'll be Miami in the national championship game along with Ohio State. Direct snap to Luke Powell. Saw this once in the first half. And he's running up the middle, shy of the 30-yard line.
If Luke Powell can pass, they would surprise everybody. Look, Tedford's alma mater, great quarterback for Fresno State, losing to San Jose State. Hey, if San Jose State wins that one, they could go to the Silicon Valley Bowl.
Right.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, Fitz Hill
has done
a great job.
Fantastic. Yes. They had one of the toughest schedules in the country.
And then they play just about everybody on the road.
On the road.
I mean, they were at Ohio State this year, beat Illinois in Champaign. I mean, that's tough. Third and 12 for Kyle Matter, back in at quarterback. Throwing with the sidelines, Teo Johnson threw his hands incomplete at the 40-yard line.
And you see why Teo Johnson is frustrated. You saw double coverage on Teo. And that's about what it's been for him all this year. especially when they know that they're not going deep. They're able to put double coverage on Dale Johnson all the time.
Well, they're going to have to spend the entire offseason trying to put some fun into what was supposed to be the fun and gun offense, because they haven't had much of either this season. Well,
they got to find a quarterback. And that's what they're going to have to find. I don't know if Kyle Matter, you know, is the right guy.
Punt rolls dead, no return possible. So Cal will get it at their own 26-yard line, 44-yard punt. Cal takes over with a 30-7 lead here in the fourth quarter of the big game. 30-7 lead here in the fourth quarter in Berkeley. 71,000 plus on hand. And they've got to be relishing this moment after 7 years of misery. And for all of these people waiting to get the axe back and waiting for the Cal program to turn around, Jeff Tedford is almost like a guy who descended from heaven.
Yeah.
I mean, they are in love with Jeff Tedford, but it's funny how other schools will look at a great turnaround situation and try to take advantage of it. And so one of the things that the Cal staff has been dealing with is questions about, hey, are you guys moving on? You've been so successful here. What about either another school making an offer? As Joe Igber is taken off. It's a foot race to the end zone, and they finally run him down inside the 20-yard line. Lee Torrance.
Touchdown saving run. And Igber over, getting close to that 200-yard mark.
56-yard run for Little Joe.
He's over 200 then.
Missed tackle. Into the secondary. Foot race, and they finally run him down.
Now, Igber, you say missed tackle. He makes guys miss. And he shakes them off. And when you try to hit him up shoulder high, you'd think a little guy like that, you would knock him down. They'd be able to pull him down. They can't. He's just too strong and powerful.
211 yards on the day, unofficially, for Joe Igber. First and 10. There's Little Joe again. Stopped by Newberry. Just to finish the thought on Tedford, he wanted to make it clear that he likes it here. Loves living in Danville. You know, wants to see the facilities upgraded, and Cal has a plan to do that. They're talking about $100 million worth of improvements on this stadium to the locker rooms as well as the weight room. And so he wants to be here and wants to get this thing going big time.
Of course, Cal fans are all remember, though, that Steve Mariucci was here for just a year and then went to the 49ers. So that, of course, keeps a lot of Cal fans on edge. They want to make certain they can keep their guy.
Second and 10. Bowler's throwing.
Got him open.
Going for one. Juggling out of the end zone.
Yeah.
Incomplete. Torrance on the coverage.
The pass was perfect. It was right there, but he just juggled. If he makes a clean catch, that's going to be a touchdown in 6 points. Great pass by Bowler. Perfect pitch, lofted it over Torrance's head.
Oh, you were right. If he fielded it cleanly, it was a touchdown.
It's a touchdown. Right there, touchdown. Whoa! Whoops, not a touchdown.
Now, Bowler is so impressive. I mean, he could throw the ball on a line, and he can also put some air on the ball. Well, that might be a lateral. I'm not sure how they're going to call
this. I don't know if they haven't called it dead. They hadn't called the ball dead, so it was still a live ball. They didn't whistle the ball dead, so it's a live ball. So that was a very smart move by Stanford, at least to hustle over there, because it could have been a live ball.
Well, they're going to set up a field goal attempt here.
Oh, Jensen has missed the point after and a field goal attempt today.
Yeah, they're calling that a fumble lateral.
So that would be the second that they've had.
Yeah, they had the other one at the start of the third quarter.
That was to the tackle. That play that they ran.
This will be a 39-yard field goal attempt for Mark Jensen.
Boy, bad day for Mark Jensen.
Yeah, he's the only Cal guy that's not going to look back at this game and really enjoy it.
I mean, he knuckled that one.
So a couple of missed field goals, a missed extra point.
And the score remains 30-7, but it's about the only thing that's gone wrong for the Bears today. They're enjoying themselves in Berkeley. Strike up the band. The Cal band having a good time with Stanford. Unable to mount any kind of comeback here in the second half, and Cal's leading 30-7.
Yeah, Joe Igber, 211 yards rushing. That's a new big game rushing record. The old mark was 209 yards by Lou Valley of Stanford in the 1956 big game. So Igber's 211 yards are also a career high, sixth best in Cal history. Yeah, and he's going to get more.
Previous best of rushing effort was 182 yards in 1999 against Washington.
You had to say that.
There's Luke Powell on a little end around there. And Luke Bantikane in the backfield in a hurry.
Luke Powell, by the way, was an option quarterback in high school. So we've seen him take the ball from behind the center from the short punt. So maybe they'll run something with him. But they're kind of running out of options besides getting the ball downfield.
Well, you know, that's where the loss of Kenneth Tolan really hurts, because he's, you know, your typical tailback. He's got the burst and explosion, can make people miss. And with him being slowed by an ankle injury, really was only in for one play, they got to try to get somebody who can make people miss in the backfield, and that is Luke Powell. Here's Matter on a quarterback draw. Well, it opens up nicely for him. Out to the 39-yard line. That's a Stanford first down. Burt Watts wrapped him. I saw Burt at the Guardsman Luncheon, which was a great, as usual, so, always a great event. At the
Bob Sarlat, the MC.
Bob Sarlat, I'll tell you what, he kills. Hilarious. He destroys everybody. There's Oski, young Cal fan.
Is Oski talking?
No. I don't think so.
Could be Oski if you talk. Matt is going to end up their top rusher.
You might be right. First and 10 from the Stanford 39. Throwing the deep ball now, looking for Teo. Bumping with Asamoah, incomplete, and no flag forthcoming.
Yeah, Asamoah had him covered deep. There was a defender bracketing him underneath, double covered all the way. That was a hard one. That was a tough one to even throw that ball, just hoping that he was going to make the play.
You know, just to finish up on the luncheon there with Sarlat, he destroys everybody. I mean, whether you're a Cal guy or a Stanford guy, you're gonna get ripped. You don't want Sarlat doing your eulogy, all right? Because if you weren't dead, you will be afterwards. Here's Matter. Here comes the pressure.
And recovered by Stanford, but boy.
Stanford got it back. Tully Bantikane.
Bantikane nailed him from behind. Does that go down as a sack? If that goes as a sack, then he's moving, inching up in the single-season sack record.
So that'll be his 13th.
That'll be his 13th. He's getting close to Andre Carter's record.
Second in the Pac-10 in sacks behind Tyrrell Suggs. Bantikane third all-time in sacks for Cal. He's got 26 and a half now. Andre Carter leads the way with 31. Third and 16. As Tully grew up in Mountain View, that's a red and white territory. But he scars for Cal. Matter throwing the deep ball.
And almost completed it to Cal.
Intended for Luke Powell, but
two defenders back there.
Yeah. Bethea was there along with Powell. Jameel Powell, that is. And so on fourth and 16, Stanford's gonna have to punt again. Ninth punt of the day.
This is like old school. 3 yards in a cloud of dust.
Well, they're trying to go.
It's only Stanford doing the 3 yards in a cloud of dust.
And this is Shank. Howell takes it. Spin move at the 34. Down at the 44-yard line. 34-yard punt and a 10-yard return. 7 minutes and 47 seconds to go. That axe will be in Cal Bear hands in a matter of minutes. 30-7, the Cal Bears. After 7 years of frustration and misery, they're going to end this losing streak in Jeff Tedford's first year as head coach.
A lot of long faces on the Stanford side. Tedford really has done a job. turning this program around. You look at it, 1-10 last year, and now he's going to have a 7-5, first winning record since 1973. That's an incredible job.
Yeah. Not too many people thought it could be done this effectively. Speaking of effective, it's little Joe Igber adding to his career day. Go back to the first play of the season under Jeff Tedford.
Bowler.
It's Tyrrell Williams on a halfback pass to David Gray for a touchdown, 71 yards against Baylor.
And they go on and hammered Baylor, 70-22.
And, you know, we asked Tedford, you know, were you trying to make a statement? He said, no, I was trying to get a touchdown. Never mind a statement. He said they had looked at films, and they decided a month and a half before the first game that they were going to run that play. They thought they could pick up something in the Baylor secondary, and they did. Chris Mandarino on the carry there for a first down. But it shows you the style. This man wants to attack. He's aggressive. And
he was a quarterback coming out of Fresno State. Jim Sweeney was the coach there. Out of that system where, you know, Fresno State, they would throw the ball, get the ball downfield. Worked with Pat Hill at Fresno State. Turned that program around. When Sweeney had left, it had gone down. And then he went up with Bellotti up in Oregon. So this is a guy who's well-schooled in offensive football.
First and 10. Igber. Tedford has done wonders for Kyle Bowler as far as his NFL potential. Joe's a little slow to get up there, but worked as we see Fresno State.
Yeah, his alma mater's not doing well. Good for San Jose State, 13-3. That is a surprise.
Yeah,
I mean, that San Jose State Spartan team is really doing well.
But as far as Tedford working with Bowler, you know, they changed his motion a little bit and really just gave him more confidence.
That's what it was, the key. It was the confidence. They did some mechanical thing and changing his throwing motion that will help him not telegraph his passes and get the ball to the receiver quickly.
Here's McConan again. And they toss him out of bounds at the 38-yard line. McConan playing with a bad shoulder almost all season long. Flag down on the play as well. He came in out of junior college and became Cal's leading receiver this year. 47 receptions for 613 yards and 7 TDs. Face mask call. See if it's 5 or 15 yards. Tacked on to the end of the play.
Yeah, coming out of that program at a City College, I mean, he was well-versed and prepared. And that just shows you what George Russ, the coach there, has done. Like I said, they were national champions when he was there.
5 yards. End of the run. Repeat second down.
So Bowler keeps moving up the ladder. I mean, basically, he's done it all in 1 year. I mean, his production. Look at him now. He's in 14th place in all-time passing as far as the Pac-10. I mean, he's passed guys like Jim Plunkett. Jack Thompson, they're throwing some more at Washington State.
Yeah, Jason Gesser of Washington State playing your Huskies still in the Apple Cup.
Yeah, don't show me that score.
He's given up. Here's Mandarino, the freshman up the middle, running hard. Stopped by Troy Freeman, Trey Freeman, that is.
Hey, you know, you got to throw the guy a bone sometime. He's blocking all day for Igber and doing a great job. So, hey, let him have a couple of carries. Young freshman doing well, got a good career ahead of him.
Be interesting to see what happens to Igber. You know, he's not really one of those guys who lives and eats and breathes football. And I'm not sure if he's that excited about pursuing an NFL career. I think he's certainly got the skill.
The quickness.
Yeah,
the skill,
yeah. Maybe not as an NFL tailback, but he could be a return guy. You know, he could help some people.
I like your analogy of Glenn Milburn. He reminds me a lot of Glenn. That size, that small. Milburn was about that size also.
Igber dropped by Lewis Hobson. Look at Joe, 219 yards on the day. Man.
You know, we talk about this 7-5 record in Cal. Three of their losses by a total of 14 points. A two-point loss to Air Force.
Right.
Two-point loss to USC. So, you know, their record very easily could have been a lot better. Another 3 points could have been 10.
The pitch to Igber. stops and starts and stops and starts. I'll tell you, this guy's so much fun to watch.
He's a treat to watch.
Svitek on the stop. He's got to be getting tired right about now. Coach, let one of the other kids play.
They're going to roll up these yardage. He's the guy. And let him run. He's the senior. This is his farewell. He said, you can rest when you retire, when you walk away from here with a degree.
He had one of his best games a couple of weeks ago against Arizona State, 144 yards rushing, but he's obliterated that today into the 220s. I remember when he was a high school player back in Hawaii. I mean, he couldn't even come close to stop. He'd get run for 300 yards a game. Here's Bowman going to the end zone again. Intended for his tight end, Brandon Hall, and double coverage there. Incomplete.
They had him bracketed pretty well during that one. Lee Torrance doing a good job. He's a deep guy.
Fourth and three. Fourth and three. We'll see for another field goal attempt.
They're going to do it until they get it right.
Mark Jensen says, I'm going to have a big game moment here if it's the last thing I do.
Been a tough day for Jensen. Two missed field goals and a missed point after.
37-yard attempt, right hash mark.
Blocked. They can advance that one, and he picks it up, and he's going to try to advance it. Well, yeah, just that was wise. And was sworn.
It's picked up or blocked by Matt Leonard and picked up by David Bergeron, I believe.
Well, Bergeron caught the kickoff, so he's doing well on the special team.
3:36 to go in the big game. Cal leading Stanford 30-7. Coming right back. Well, this is a good day to be dressed up as a bear.
This is the only day.
Unless you're Mark Jensen, who's having his problems here, Martin.
Hey, he's the only bear. Blocked field goal. He already missed two others and a point after. Bergeron returns it. Jensen, stay away. Don't try to make the tackle. Nothing good's happening for you today. He gets in and gets hit and knocked down. Poor guy. He's on the bottom of the pile. Are they going to be partying on Telegraph and Shattuck tonight?
Oh, you better believe it. Great look, by the way, by the guys in our truck. Ted Griggs producing. Tommy Adza directing. The entire camera crew.
They're getting ready to party here now. The guys are already chanting. Give us the axe, give us the axe, give us the axe. Cal Bear supporters getting ready.
Casey Moore on the last carry there as the clock begins to wind down.
Casey Moore missed a big game, not today.
Now Kyle Bowler's had the big game, a couple of touchdown passes to LaShawn Ward and Joe Igber just running wild. Kyle Matter's gone the whole way, quarterback to Stanford. Nice catch by Alex Smith in traffic out to the 30 in the first down.
Good hands. Smith with good hands. As I said, his dad is an NFL player, former NFL player.
You know, you look at that, that's one of the things that's so perplexing and frustrating for Stanford. You look at, well, that was beautifully done. And you just
the schemes are there.
Occasionally you get it, but you just don't get it consistently enough.
The schemes are there. They do have some talent. I mean, obviously, Tayo Johnson is a great talent. LaShawn Ward's a talent. They got some talent with offensive linemen. But, hey, you got a freshman quarterback.
Right.
You got to have somebody to make the decisions and pull the trigger.
Play action for Matter. Throwing it out to Casey Moore.
And that's a holding.
Incomplete.
You can see that one. One of the big, that's Quame Harris with the hole on that one. That's going to go back for Stanford. Stanford offensive lineman out of Newark. Guy's an All-American possibility, Quame Harris.
Yeah,
he's been there a long time.
Most athletic offensive lineman up front for Stanford. And they're starting to make some noise here in Berkeley.
Give us the axe.
On the offense, 10 yards, clear spot, three first down.
Well, it's nice, you know, one of the things is you look at LaShawn Ward there, he's had a great day, his final day, a couple of touchdown catches. Is it, they want to see a packed house here in Berkeley with regularity.
Yeah. And that is one of the things that Tedford did allude to that surprised him. That when they started winning, and after some of their big wins, they came back home, crowds of like 28, 29,000. That was a surprise to them. Of course, at Oregon, they're always sold out.
30-7 our score. Ryan Wells, a senior playing his final game, with stiff arm spin move. And out to the 36-yard line. Nice play. Gain of 16.
And the beautiful thing you see about these kids at Stanford, they are fighting. They haven't quit. They're battling. Even Kyle Matter. I mean, here's a freshman. He's getting beat up and pushed around. There's a guy down on the field, an injured Stanford lineman. But they are really, oh, that's Tao Johnson that's down. And that doesn't look good.
Tao Johnson is down, and I just hope this is not a serious injury. Basically, at a time of the game where the winner has long since been decided.
Yeah, Mike Montgomery is holding his breath right now at home. And he expected to have Tao training with him within a couple of days. Because they've got one more game, I think, back east. And then when they come back, they only have one game in December. Let's see if we can see how he hurts himself. He's trying to make a block
at the right corner of his screen.
Here he is right here. Tao making the block. Oh, he's caught right there. It's hit a little bit by one of Cal's men, kind of whiplashed his leg. I hate to say it, but it looked like.
Yeah, Tao on the left side of the screen.
Here he is right there.
That's
right there.
Hunter. That's Hunter.
He got hit.
Wendell Hunter.
In the lower left leg. It looked like his foot was still planted, and boy, he is limping real.
Yeah, he's not able to put any weight on that left leg.
That left leg. Foot was planted, and he can't believe it. Big game.
Yeah,
I got 2 minutes left for basketball.
It makes you wonder whether maybe they should have just gotten him out of there, he and Luke Powell, with. You know, on the other side of the coin, it's a rivalry game. They're trying to make something happen here. They're not going to win the game, but try to build on something for next season. So you can see both sides. Oh, that was almost intercepted.
He had read that one, had jumped on top of that one, and was ready to go. Jameel Powell was going to the house.
Earlier today, the big splash. Water polo, Cal versus Stanford. You saw Cal scoring first, Stanford scoring second, and Stanford won that game.
All right. The Cardinal. Hey, Jameel Powell thought he was gone to the house. He just didn't catch the ball.
Well, that scene
says it all.
It says it all right there. Trey Freeman and the rest of the Cardinal players. This is not the way they wanted to go out. Matter. Complete, still flinging. Grant Mason with a reception. He's part of the future of the program, freshman from Michigan.
First loss for Stanford team in the big game in 7 years.
7 years.
Seven straight they won. So
here's Tao.
It's Tao. They're working on him.
I really hope that this is nothing serious for him. He is such a good kid. You know, he's involved in a mentoring program. So between playing football and basketball, there's a young man that he's helping to mentor and. Takes him out and helps him with schoolwork and stuff. I mean, he's just a great kid.
And from San Diego, his sister's a student at Cal.
There's the sack of Matter. Nixon.
Matt Nixon.
That was Tom Canada.
The man from Hancock, JC. The senior. Got himself a sack. That's not bad on the stat list.
He's got 10 sacks on the season. Cal with 24 seniors who have less than a minute and a half left in their collegiate careers. Stanford will say goodbye to 16 of their seniors.
But they're leaving with a winning season. And that's something that Cal hasn't been able to say in their whole tenure here.
And those crutches are for Tao Johnson.
Bringing the crutches out. That's not good.
There's Matter stepping up. And he's going to run with it. And saves his life wisely.
Did not get the first down. And he's down. Matter's down.
And there's Tao.
Tao's moving off on crutches.
Well, I'll tell you what, if that's a serious injury to either Matter or to Tao, it would really be the final crushing blow to
you talk about
a
insult,
horrendous season.
Injury added to insult. For Tao, it's already been a frustrating season for him. But the guy loves to play football, says he loves basketball more. And really, it's hard for him to make a decision. But we can see that he's hurt.
There are the stats on Matter.
Matter took a dive. There was, it looks like they're Cal fans on the other side. They were really getting ready.
Yeah, they are about to swarm the field here. So
swarm the field and go get the axe.
I hope for his sake that the guy in the Stanford tree outfit is long gone, because
well, Matter is up on the sideline trying to shake it off. So that's good news. They took off his helmet.
Ryan Eklund is going to come in. He's a sophomore, 6'7", out of Washington. There are the fans ready to swarm the field here.
Cal students finally going to get their hands on the axe. Ryan Eklund, he's got some size.
He's one of the biggest quarterbacks you're ever going to see.
Out of Washington. How did he get away from the University of Washington?
It's always about Washington, isn't it, Martin?
You have to wonder.
Alex Smith with the catch. We're under a minute here.
The Kyle Bowler, got to be happy for Kyle. That guy personally.
Jump on his back. That's just what he needs. That's a first-round draft pick, baby, in the NFL.
He don't care. He's happy. I mean, he's going away finally with a big-game victory and a winning season. I mean, after the 3 years that he suffered through.
After all the misery. He said, you know, the one thing about the losing is, I mean, it was horrible frustration. We got the flags flying and movement up front against Stanford, but with all of the frustration, you know, the winning is that much sweeter. Here's 1997.
Yeah, and of course this was at Stanford, and there was hey, you remember what happened at Miami, Ohio with the game of Marshall last week? I mean, that is not, look at them, they're all there on the edge of the field. They're gonna swarm this field. I mean, this is not something I would like to be. I think the players are going to have to get off the field real quick. The security is gone. Forget about it. There's no way they're going to stop them from not rushing the field. And it's going to happen. Kyle Bowler, Jeff Tedford, what a job he's done. Guy that's attention to detail, made a family atmosphere, communicating with all these players, giving them confidence that they can make it happen, and they've done it.
Changing the attitude around completely. 25 seconds left. This could be the final play, and I tell you, it's going to be a mass of humanity attacking the field here.
It's going to be a scene like the NCAA basketball championship when the fans swarm the court, only this is a 120-yard football field.
Complete to Wells, and there's Bowler enjoying his final few moments. It's all finally come to fruition, and he's going to leave Cal with a victory in the big game.
I wonder if they'll carry Tedford off. If they'll carry him on this. They can't.
I mean, where they're going to
carry him. There won't be any room.
But they could pass him around the stadium.
My goodness. And the Stanford players, they have to be a little bit concerned. They're looking around at all these guys, the fans that are going to start pouring out of the stands. How are they going to get back through the fans to their locker?
There was the Gatorade splash for Jeff Tedford.
He won't get the ride, but he'll get the old Gatorade splash.
And I'll tell you what, if you look behind the Cal bench here, it's all fans.
It's all fans.
I mean, it's just...
They're on the bench.
Yeah, they have just taken over the side.
The band is on the... No, the band is on the bench.
No, we did that already 20 years ago.
The band is on the bench, my goodness. Only at Cal. Only in the big game.
Now, let's just hope all the Stanford guys get out of here safely.
You know, if this was Florida, Florida State, Michigan, Ohio State, they would have a problem. But, you know, this is more of a friendly rivalry. And Cal gets the ball.
And it ends in fitting fashion for the Cal Bears. Tom Canada causing the fumble.
They're on the field, but the game is not over yet.
11 seconds.
They didn't learn from 82.
I think they're just going to.
It's not over yet.
I think it is over. They're going to call it a day. The officials are trying to get out of here.
The fans have taken the field. The game's not over. It's still 11 seconds yet. They can score 3 touchdowns in 11 seconds. Well, maybe not.
And they did wind the clock, and they just set it to 0-0.
Now they're really hitting the field. Unbelievable. Only in the big game. Only at Memorial Stadium. Well, it happened 2 years ago, 97 at Stanford.
And the axe officially has changed hands.
We're looking for the axe. I'm trying to find it. There it is. They're going to bring it out. And they've got it so everybody can see it.
And the Cal Bears, behind Kyle Bowler and Joe Igber, finished the season at 7-5. Their first winning season since 93. The axe belongs to them.
Well deserved, Jeff Tedford. If you don't get a ride off on their shoulders, hey, we'll give it to you verbally. You did a great job, you and your staff. Bob Gregory, the defensive coordinator, outstanding. And that kid, Kyle Bowler, you gotta love it for him. He's going to get that rep. All right, yeah. 3 years. Guy comes out of high school, one of the most highly recruited quarterbacks in the country. Comes to Cal. Three frustrating, losing years, lost confidence in himself, but stayed with him. Almost quit playing football altogether.
He said he never stopped believing in himself. He would see guys play in the NFL and say, you know, I can be that good, but
this ain't fun.
But it wasn't fun, and now it's fun. Now it is fun. And he may have a great pro career because he certainly got the arm.
And you know he's got the heart, the perseverance, and the ability. You've got to say, hey, if this guy's going to be picked up first, second round in the NFL draft. Cal fans finally get to touch the axe. They hadn't seen this thing in, what, 8 years?
We got the cannon going off, the fireworks, and it is going to be quite a night in Berkeley.
It's an old
of the 105th edition of the Big Game. Cal winning it 30-7. Thanks for joining us. Stay tuned. We're coming back with our final thoughts. It's a final. Cal beats Stanford 30-7 in the Big Game. Martin, tell us straight that goalpost there. They've got it surrounded there.
I mean, look at the security around the goalpost because they didn't want the fans to pull it down and somebody could possibly get injured. They tried to assault. They made an assault on that goalpost, but the security guys were able to fight them off. But, man, they've been really going at it right in here. Right in there. Those fans are determined. We're going to tear that goalpost down. But you see a whole cadre of security.
We're hoping to get down to Mike Schumann on the field, but he's somewhere in the midst of the bedlam. We did have an opportunity earlier in the week to talk with some of the Cal players. We asked them, what would it feel like? What kind of a dream would it be to get your hands on the axe, finally?
This week, I'm sure I'll lay in bed and just, it'll go over my head over and over. I'll be going through plays and hopefully the sign of the axe, you know, waving it, you know, to my parents, showing them finally we got it back. And it'll just be so special. It'll be, I think it'll be very emotional.
I think it's gonna be the locker room talk, the weight room talk, on the field talk, you know, everyone's gonna be talking about it.
I've imagined it for 4 years now, so I hope to get a reality of it this time, but you know, it'll be great. It'll be a great moment.
Well, they will have a chance to grab that axe, assuming they can find it somewhere in the mayhem down on the field. But it is just, it's a cluster of humanity.
Yeah, Mike Schumann is down there somewhere. He was going to grab the winning coach. Hey, forget that. He can't even get across the field. It's amazing that so many years, and now to get it, it's got to be a great feeling. It makes it even more important.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Coach Tedford. The fans eating it up after a 30-7 victory.
There's the axe.
Right back to Berkeley. Well, so much for security, Martin. The goalpost is coming down.
You just knew it was going to happen. It was just a mass of humanity. Those students were determined. We're going to take this goalpost down, and you see it. Hopefully, nobody will get injured. I mean, look at those three guys up there putting their weight to it. But, you know, those goalposts weigh a lot, and that's why the schools don't want to see one pulled down because somebody could get hurt and be a lot of liability.
Well, I'll tell you what, yeah, it looks like it's about to tip right now after all of the frustration of the past 7 years.
There she blows.
I don't want to be the guy on the top side of that.
There she blows, as they say.
Well, hey. You know, they're having some fun. And
we're having fun. This is a big game. What an atmosphere. If nobody gets hurt, this is one of the greatest adventures that you can have.
And the Cal Athletic Department will gladly pay for some new goalposts after all they've endured over the past few years. But they do finally win it 30-7, and they get a 7-5 season for Jeff Tedford in his first year. We'll take a look at some of the highlights in case you joined us late. But it all started off, actually, with Stanford, Teo Johnson, a touchdown catch.
And, of course, Teo left the game in the last 2 minutes with a knee injury. It looked like a knee injury, so we hope that he'll be all right.
LaShawn Ward starred in the first half. Kyle Bowler hooking up with him on a touchdown of 31 yards to tie the game at 7 apiece. And after a field goal of 23 yards by Mark Jensen to make it 10-7, Bowler goes up top again to Ward in the back of the end zone. 22 yards, extra point, no good, but it was 16-7, and little Joe Igber put on a show.
Huge game, 142 yards in the first half. He would go on and rush for a big game record, about 240-some yards, a big game single-day rushing record.
And here is Jameel Powell with the only score of the second half off the punt return, early third quarter, and he takes it to the house, 84 yards. And another one of the seniors, Kyle Bowler, Jameel Powell, Joe Igber, if you're
big
a senior,
games,
this is the way to go out.
The way they wanted to go out with the victory and with a winning season, and they can look at it and say, hey, we helped turn this program around, because they can see that Jeff Tedford has it on the right path. We were the class that made it happen and helped turn it around.
So Cal goes 7-5. They finally get the axe back. You're Stanford and Buddy Tevens. Boy, a tough first year, 2-9. Where do you go from here?
Well, they get 1 year. You get 1 year free. Now, next year, they're going to have to pick it up. It's going to be a tough one for them, I tell you, because Buddy Tevens and Stanford, they've got to recruit, especially a quarterback.
And you can see they did take the goalpost down. That'll do it for our entire ABC7 crew. And Martin Wyatt, Mike Schumann, I'm Larry Beal. Thanks for watching, everybody. So long.